Arkistas, and welcome back to PLM Architecture YouTube channel. Ayan, happy new year to everyone. How's 2021 going on for you guys so far? And also, we would also like to welcome you to the latter half of the first semester of this academic year. Ayan, today is January 10th, and kamusta naman ang first 10 days of 2021 for you guys? And you can comment your thoughts or sentiments on our comment section right here. And also, kindly include your year and your block if you are from KAUP and your school naman if you are from another university for us to acknowledge the presence of our live viewers who are with us today. Thank you guys for lending your time for us on a Sunday. And talaga namang hindi tayo magsisisi dahil today for sure, we will acquire a lot of learnings from today's webinar.
That is right. Today's episode will be so exciting as we prepared topics that will be vital to our academic journey and personal development. And of course, we would like to thank our generous sponsors who made this episode possible today. Huge thanks to Boujee Shop, MNL, and Sweet Hangover. Kindly visit their Facebook page and Instagram at Boujee.shop, MNL, and Sweet Hangover to know more about their lovely and promising products. Stay tuned until the end because we will have a giveaway courtesy of our lovely sponsors. Once again, good afternoon, everyone. I am Prince Saldin Jose.
And I am Angeli Pastrano, and welcome to the third episode of Arkitekturo, an online lecture series presented to you by the College of Architecture and Urban Planning Student Council. Nako, mukhang excited ako sa pag-giveaway na yan ng ating sponsors, ha? So, pakaabangan natin yan, mga live viewers natin, until the end. Also, guys, you can tweet us with the hashtag, #Arkitekturo_F3. On Twitter, or tag us on your IG stories with your creative snapshots. It's at KAUPSC Official on Twitter and Instagram. Also, don't forget to like our Facebook page, PLM KAUP Student Council. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram. It's at KAUPSC Official. And support our One View, One Step Forward campaign by watching and subscribing to our YouTube channel. It's PLM Architecture.
And just a little house rules, if you have questions regarding to our topic, kindly type them in our comment section or save them up for later after the discussion. Please remember to keep your comments professional and relevant to the topic.
That is right. So wag na natin pong patagalin pa, and let us begin with today's webinar. Allow me to introduce to you our first guest speaker, who has been working as a chief trainer handling the training and development programs for 16 years in Drug Check, Philippines. He has partnered with the Philippine Council of NGOs against drug and substance abuse and served as their spokesperson for 12 years. In 2012, he was part of the team that initiated the revision of life skills training for the use of the Pagsasanay ng Pamilyang Filipino program. He was being recognized internationally as he became a pioneer member of the Pool of Global Master Trainers for International Society of Substance Use Prevention and Treatment Professionals of the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime at Vienna, Austria. And an alumnus of the International Visitors Leadership Program in the United States of America, the most prestigious exchange programs in the world. It is with great honor to introduce to you our first guest speaker to talk about 8 traits to be great. Please welcome Sir Santaner Tedranes Iray. Good afternoon po, sir.
Good afternoon po, sir.
Hello, good afternoon, and thank you so much for inviting me here. And I'm so excited. I always believe that we don't really have to stop from learning because we only stop learning when we are dead. So as long as you live, you continue to learn. And the good thing about learning, once you have learned, then you have to share that learning to others so that we would be able to inspire other people to be inspired also. We need to motivate ourselves to motivate other people. I always believe that we don't have to stop from telling our stories, because when we tell our stories, we know better. When we know better, we do better. And when we do better, we become greater. And for us to achieve that greatness, we should have some traits to be great. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to our topic, 8 traits to be great.
Thank you so much, Pozen Sir, for granting your time to us for today's episode. So now we will provide you po the screen na to begin po with your presentation. Thank you, Pozen.
All right. Thank you so much. For the past 10 years, if I may ask our live viewers, what significant change have you observed to the world or the universe for the past 10 years? Maybe you have your own observation of what are those changes that had happened for the past 10 years. And just to give you an example, there are 3 things that you cannot recover in the world. The first one is the word that you say. The person might be able to forgive you, but not be able to forget what you've said. Second is the moments that are missed. And third, the time that has gone. So we really have to think about that one. Change, there's nothing permanent in the world except change. For 10 years, for the past 10 years, what is that significant change that you have observed? In our first part of the slide, for 10 years, cameraman and pilot both lost their jobs because of the drone, because of the invention of the drone. And what does it mean to us? You need to upgrade yourself. You need to think outside of your box. You need to go out from your comfort zone, because there are 3 C's in our lives. Tatlong C. The first one is the comfort zone. You don't want to go out. You don't want to go out because you are already in your comfortability zone. But please, you have to challenge yourself. You have to go out from your current zone to realize that that is where you are good at. You need to do even better. You need to do even more, all right? So that when you have reached already your current zone, you will not get into your crazy zone. And you will realize that what if you have a lot of what ifs, but we really have to change that what ifs to what is. Like, if you look at this example, at this lesson that we have learned from this, in 10 years, both cameramen and pilot lost their jobs. You need to upgrade yourselves. And what else can we learn from this topic today? 2 stories to begin with. Nokia refused Android. If I may share, during my years, yung naalala ko before is yung gamit for communication is RCPI. I just don't know if you have also encountered that one, if you can still remember that one, but I'm 42 years old right now. At yung naabutan ko noon is RCPI. It's a kind of telegram. Yan yung pinakamabilis before if you want to send your message to the people you love. Telegram within the national level. I mean in the local, meaning in the Philippines. Telegram, RCPI was really very popular before. The letters that your loved one has sent you will be able to receive that one for 3 days or 4 days. Yan yung pinakamabilis. Hindi pa uso dati yung text, all right? Hindi pa uso dati yung cellphone. Hindi pa uso dati yung what we are enjoying right now. Dati yung RCPI pa lang, a kind of telegram, nagbago po yan. I don't know if naabutan nyo po yung pager, like the pocket bell, all right? Yung beeper na tinatawag nila, all right? Yun yung sumunod. And then nawala din po yun. Kasi ang problema ng beeper is you need to run through the telephone. Ibig sabihin, dadaan ka sa telephone operator para isend pa yung message niya. Message mo. Doon sa papadalan mo ng message. At nawala po yun. Alright? Nawala po yung pager. Bakit po? The first mobile was invented. Ano po yung first mobile? Naalala niyo po yung analog, yung pangkaskas na yelo na napakalaki, na kapag tinapon sa'yo ay mawawalan ka ng malay. That was the first mobile phone. That was the first portable phone. At nawala po ito. Bakit? Kasi nagkaroon po ng kauna-unahang cellphone na yung brand is Boujee, na si Aga Mulak po yung endorser. at nawala po ito kasi nagkaroon po during the 90s, si Rico yan ang nag-endorse ng Alcatel. Naalala niyo po ba yung parang sabon yung kanyang shape, alright, na yung kanyang backlight is color orange? I don't know if you can still recall that one. And nagkaroon ng Motorola, nagkaroon ng Sony Ericsson, and the first branded mobile was your Nokia 5110, yung may antenna. At kapag nasira yung antenna, nilalagyan mo ng rubber band. At nawala yung Nokia 5110, napalitan po ito ng Nokia 3210. Kung naalala nyo po, wala na itong antenna, pero malaki yung kanyang yung mukha ng cellphone na pwede mong gawan din ng backlight. And then nawala po ito kasi nagkaroon ng Nokia 3310. Can you recall yung silver version na pwede mong palitan ng housing? At nawala po ito, yung Nokia 3310. Kasi during the Matrix, meron po yung tinatawag na yung the Matrix phone. During the movie, alright, during the movie of Keanu Reeves at the Matrix, kaya nagkaroon ng Matrix phone. Tapos hindi pa rin natapos dito, nagkaroon ng Nokia 8210. I just don't know if you can recall yung blue and red version. At nawala yung Nokia 8210, napalitan ng Nokia 8250. Nawala yung Nokia 8250 kasi napalitan ito ng BB or BlackBerry. At nawala yung BlackBerry, napalitan ito ng kung ano-anong klase ng mobile phone. There's Oppo, there's actually Vivo, and of course, there's Apple. At ano yung nagbago sa mundo? Alright? At nagbago ang mundo nang dahil sa cellphone mo. How I wish sana wala na lang ito. Bakit po? Because this is my observation. Nang dahil sa cellphone, lumalabas kayong mag-anak pero kayo lahat ay nakatingin sa cellphone. Yes, kumakain kayo ng sabay-sabay pero lahat kayo nakatutok or doon sa cellphone nakatingin. Dati-dati, bago kumain, nagdadasal. But these days, bago kumain, pinipicturan yung pagkain because everything should be Instagrammable. I am not saying technology or high-tech gadgets are not needed. I'm not saying it's bad. But I think we really have to realize and ponder on what's really the essence of life. In the change of technology, in the change of high-tech gadgets, we really have to go back to our core. What is that core of what really matters? What is really the important parts in our lives? And basically, if we are already professionals, whether you are architect, whether you are accountant, whether you are a public speaker, the most important part is your core. It's your values. Use the values that you have learned from your parents, from your grandparents, for you to be able to succeed in life. That's what basically life is all about. And success is definitely the success that you want to achieve, pag ready ka na, may responsibility po yan. Alright? And that responsibility, when you are okay, when you are ready at naset mo na yung sarili mo, alright, ready mo nang i-achieve yung blessing na yan. But let's go back to the story. Nokia refused Android. Would you imagine if Nokia dominated already the brand of mobile? If Nokia did not refuse Android, then maybe they are too powerful combination. The merger could have been one of the best in the communication industry. But Nokia refused Android. Right now, Android is still there. Nokia, I think they have already ceased their operation in the Philippines. So Nokia refused Android. And then if you go back, you need to upgrade yourself. Another story, Yahoo refused Google. Yahoo is still there. But of course, Google is, I think, in Google we trust. So you have to agree with me that if you need anything, then you have to Google. All right? So if Yahoo did say yes to Google, then that could also be a most powerful merger in the history. All right. So what are the lessons that we have learned from these two stories? First is you need to take risks. I know those successful people failed at first, but they are not successful if they were not able to take risk. Life is about taking risk. All right. What if? So what if should actually be changed to what is. So take that risk because only those risk takers would succeed. And then you need to embrace changes because nothing is permanent in the world except change. I love doing face-to-face lecture, face-to-face lecture, but because of the pandemic and because the quarantine protocols allowed 30 persons only, so the face-to-face approach of doing the lecture, since I am an animated speaker and I want to connect to my audience, I just don't know if I'm connected with you in there. Well, you are listening to me because I only have my laptop here and my presentation and myself, and I just don't know if you are reacting the same way, if you are interactive right now, and if you're learning from me, I don't know your impression. I just also don't know your reaction to what I am telling you. But what I am telling you is this: you really have to go out from thinking outside the box. You really have to go into your current zone for you to be able to realize that you can do even better. All right, right now, and the first invitation to me are there are powerful women in the architectural field, and it's okay. Empowered women also empowered other people. And when you are empowered, then you inspire other people to be empowered. And whether you are in the field of science, of medicine, or anything, it is not about the job that you do. It is not about the course that you have taken, but it is the amount of love that you put into what you do. I just don't know if you feel me. I have energy. Although I'm doing a monologue, I just have myself on my mirror. I just have myself on my presentation. But if you feel me right, then it is the love to what you do that matters. I love what I do. I speak every day. I have 3 invitations in one day, and I just deliver the same energy. So whether you are in whatever, whether you are in architecture, whether you are in the accounting field, or whatever it is that you do right now, it is not about what you do, but it is about how much love you put to what you do. And embracing the change of time, challenging yourself, especially in the new normal, especially in the new normal, I'm telling you, all right, you really have to step up your game if you want to stay in there or to stay on the top, all right? Because if you refuse to change with time, you might perish. Again, if you refuse to change with time, you might perish. You really have to step up. If there's no technology, you really have to study. If there's new innovation, you really have to embrace yourself with those new innovation. That's what I'm telling you. And 2 more stories. Facebook, believe me, takes over WhatsApp and Instagram. We are in the Philippines, we are not a WhatsApp user, but in other countries and some of my friends in the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, we communicate through WhatsApp, but of course Instagram. But believe me, Facebook took over Instagram and WhatsApp. That's why if you are going to post your Instagram photos, then there is a link if you also want it to be posted to your Facebook account. The reason in there is Facebook takes over WhatsApp and Instagram. And of course, alam na alam po natin ito, Grab takes over Uber. All right? So anong natutunan natin dito sa mga taking over, all right, of Facebook taking over WhatsApp and Instagram and Grab taking over Uber? Anong natutunan natin dito? 1, you have to become so powerful that your competitors become your allies. If you cannot beat them, you join them. That's simple as it is. All right? And 2, you have to reach the top position and then eliminate the competition. And you need to keep innovating. You really have to step up your game. I've told you, you really have to step up your game. And 2 more stories. Colonel Sanders founded KFC at the age of 65. Ulitin ko po, when you think about chicken, of course, when I went to Kentucky, one of the states in the United States, you don't mention in there Kentucky Fried Chicken. When you mention fried chicken, it's understood to be Kentucky. But the lesson that we have to learn from this, would you believe me if I tell you that Colonel Sanders founded KFC at the age of 65, and Jack Ma, who couldn't get a job from KFC, founded his own Alibaba? I'll tell you that again. Colonel Sanders founded KFC at the age of 65. And Jack Ma, of course, who is a friend of Manny Pacquiao, was actually given a lot of PPEs to the frontliners in the Philippines. Jack Ma, who couldn't get a job from KFC, founded his own Alibaba. So what are the lessons that we have to learn from these stories? Unang-una, age is just a number. I've mentioned earlier, it does not mean that you are 75, you stop from learning, because you only stop learning when you are dead. And so as long as you live, you continue to learn. So it is not about the age. Age is just a number. In fact, age is just a word. It is never never a statement. And only those who keep trying succeeds. Lagi natin itong sinasabi. Try and try and try. Lagi nating susubukan kasi para hindi tayo magkaroon ng alinlangan sa sarili natin na what if ginawa ko ito? So paano mo malalaman na kaya mo kasi hindi mo ginawa? Alright? So age is just a number and only those who keep trying succeeds. That's what we have learned from the story of Colonel Sanders and Jack Ma. And the last story that I'm going to share with you today or this afternoon is the Lamborghini. Or Lamborghini was founded as a result of a revenge of a tractor owner who was insulted by Enzo Ferrari, the founder of Ferrari. Ulitin ko lang po ah. Lamborghini was founded as a result of a revenge of a tractor owner who was insulted by Enzo Ferrari, the founder of Ferrari. Ferrari, mas nauna siya kaysa sa Lamborghini, but Lamborghini remains to be one of the powerful brands in the car industry. In fact, mas expensive pa siya sa Ferrari. So ano yung natutunan nating lesson dito? Na yung Lamborghini was founded as a result of a revenge of a tractor owner who was insulted by Enzo Ferrari, the founder of Ferrari. Ito yung mga lessons natin. Unang-una, never underestimate anyone ever. You don't have to choose kung sinong kakausapin mo because even the dumb and the dull that you think has their own stories to tell. The garbage collector outside, when you talk to the person, he or she has a powerful story to inspire you. And success is the best revenge. Pag iniwanan ka, may darating na mas okay na hindi ka sasaktan at hindi ka pahihirapan. Take it from Basha and Popoy. That is your best revenge. Pag ikaw nawala ng opportunities, if the door is closed, believe me, the window will definitely open. So success is the best revenge. That's the best motivation in life. And believe me, if you were rejected, it is okay. I'll say that again. If you have experienced rejection in your life, it is okay because rejection is not rejection at all. It is redirecting you to something better. I'll say that again. Rejection is not rejection at all. It is redirecting you to something better. All right. Now, moving on from the lessons of the stories, from the stories that we have learned this afternoon, ano-ano ba yung summary or five major lessons that we have learned from those stories? In summary, yung pinaka-importante dito, yung una is just keep working hard. All right? Just keep working hard. No matter what you do in life, just keep working hard. Do not just allow yourself to deliver in a mediocrity because you can do excellent job. When you are given a chance, believe me, do it as if your last day. Do it as if you are going to be fired today. Because when you have that kind of mindset, believe me, you will definitely succeed in life. And invest your time wisely. Ibig sabihin, time, not just time, but resources and relationship. So invest your time, your money, your energy, wisely, all right? In a relationship, you have to choose people who choose you, all right? You don't have to waste your time. You don't have to waste your time to people who do not see your worth. So invest your time to people that sees your worth, that sees your talent, your skills, that nurture you. You have to choose people who choose you. So in here, invest your time wisely and do not be afraid to fail because all successful people failed at first. You've heard a lot of stories from those successful business tycoons. They have failed at first. I failed a lot of times. I've recovered a lot of times. And right now, if I may say, I am at the top of my game. May not be a millionaire today, but I am happy. I am happy when I see other people happy because of me. When you see other people happy because of you, I think that's the greatest achievement that you can be proud of and show to the world that you were once an instrument of making other people happy. And that is success. All right? And be great in everything that you do. All right? Be great in everything that you do. No matter what you do, be great in it. And do not limit yourself to what you can do. I've mentioned this earlier. I've said this earlier. You can do even better. So, how do people learn? Paano ba tayo natututo? If you will just listen to me, you remember 20%. If you will just listen, so you will remember 20%. But if you look at the information I gave you, you will remember 30%. But if you listen to me and you look at the information, when you combine both, then you will remember 50%. But if you talk, like after our webinar, all right, and if you talk it from your colleague, what you have learned, if you share it, then you will remember 70%. Pero kapag in-apply mo, yung natutunan mo sa akin, maybe be one word, all right, that changed your perspective in life, that inspire you, that motivated you, then you will remember 90%. Kasi useless lang tong webinar na to if there is no application. It is the application. It is applying what you have learned from me. Pero the question is, bakit walang 100%? The answer is, hindi kaya lahat i-absorb ng utak mo. And right now, if napilitan ka lang dyan sa screen mo na mag-live stream sa YouTube, and if you're going through something else, and if you feel that this architecture course for you is not really for you, and if you feel that you are failing, and if you feel that you might actually drop, I am telling you, it is okay not to be okay. It is okay not to be okay. Hindi kaya lahat i-absorb ng utak mo. You need some kind of a breath of gap. Breath of gap is to give yourself the time to think, to rethink, recalibrate, reassess yourself to where you really would want to be. All right? Kasi tingnan mo, ATM machines have cash limit. Yung exams have time limit, right? Diba? And even the memory card, meron yung mga certain limitations. Kaya tayo din, yung overthinking natin, meron din yung limitations. So you need a breath of gap. It is a gift. Alright? You need to take a pause. Kailangan huminto ka muna. Oh? I-assess mo muna yung sarili mo. Alright? And I think, ang ganda lang ng combination because I am teaching you the life skills, and later on, you will be taught on the technical aspect. So a perfect combination of both. All right, it's really a perfect combination of both. Thank you for those who invited me, and at the same time, para dun sa nag-initiate ng program to include actually life skills. Life skills is very powerful. Itong dinidiscuss ko sa inyo, this is life skills. Ito yung mga lessons that we have learned from the experts, from those successful people. And there's nothing wrong if you are going to try adopting it, to try like doing benchmarks out from it. Kasi ito, evidence-based. And we move to evidence-based. Hindi dapat hearsay lang. Dapat evidence-based. May ebidensya dito. Na mga tao na to, these are the traits that work for them. And they just want to inspire people. Baka this will also work for other people. But I'm telling you, what worked with other people may not actually work with you. But if you have given it a try and give it a try for yourself, benchmark ang tawag dun, baka mag-work. All right? There's no harm in trying. Ay sabi nga, try and try. Okay? And right now, if you are listening to me, you just have to choose which one represents your current state of your heart. All right? Which object represents the current state of your heart? So there is, yung una nating item is lobo. Yung pangalawa is neon lights or bar lights. Yung pangatlo is wheelbarrow, yung ginagamit sa construction. And yung pang-apat is gold watch. I'm going to give you a time. Since I am not seeing you, I'm going to give you 3 seconds to think which object, all right, best fit to what you feel right now. Is it lobo? All right. Is it neon lights or bar lights? Is it wheelbarrow, yung ginagamit sa construction, or is it gold watch? So I'll give you 3 seconds, and time is up, okay? Because I was just given 1 hour, and this talk is good for 3 hours. I can definitely talk to you for 3 hours, but I was just given a very limited time na 1 hour lang. So kung lobo ang pinili mo, anong ibig sabihin niyan? Ano ang laman ng lobo? May helium siya. In other words, meron siyang hangin. So marami sa atin ay may ego. But what I'm telling you is you need to silence your ego so that your power will become great. Ulitin ko lang po. You need to silence your ego so that your power will become great. Nobody has the monopoly of knowledge. Huwag mong iisipin na ikaw lagi ang marunong at may alam. Alright? And kapag ikaw ay marunong at may alam or magaling ka, lagi mong iisipin ito. And take it from me, lagi ka pa dapat na mas magiging mas mapakumbaba. Bakit? Kasi may darating at darating na mas magaling pa kesa sa'yo. Ulitin ko lang po ah, kasi this is really so powerful, okay? And especially for the young people out there, I know you are chasing your dreams. Marami ka talagang dreams sa buhay. And you are also in a marathon of your life to achieve your dreams. Alright, kalma ka lang, chill ka lang. Alright, pero just in case na nandun ka na, naging okay ka na, lagi mong tatandaan, there is this balloon personality. Anong ibig sabihin? Lahat yan merong angas. Merong yung tinatago sa loob na ego. Pero gusto ko lang sabihin na dapat pag magaling ka, mas lalo ka pang maging mas mapakumbaba kasi meron at meron pang darating na mas magaling pa kaysa sa'yo. Humility is a power. You need to silence your ego so that your power will become great. Kung pinili mo naman ay neon lights or bar lights, it represents your creative ideas. Ang galing kasi yung bar lights na to, punong-puno siya ng kulay. That means po, lahat ng mga ideas mo are creative. Ang problema, sa dami mong ideas, wala ka pang natatapos. Yan ang problema ng mga young people ngayon. They jump from one job to the other. Promise. Ayan. That's really evidence-based. They jump from one job to the other. Pag di nila nagustuhan tong trabaho na to, they will jump and go to other companies. Kasi nga, wala silang patience. Oh, at the same time, they actually lost their focus on what they want to do. Kaya eto na to, sobrang galing. Yeah, maraming magagaling, especially yung mga young people right now. Magagaling yan. Creative yung ideas nila. Ang problema, sa sobrang nilang gusto, daming gustong gawin, wala pa silang nagagawa, wala pa silang natatapos. Ang tawag dyan ay bar lights kind of personality. Magaling ka, matalino ka, creative ang ideas mo. But the problem is, wala kang focus. Alright? Kaya, ano ang ending? You are a master of none. Wala kang natatapos. Okay? So, I have to speed up a little bit. Ito naman po ay wheelbarrow. So, ito po ay may kinalaman sa mentoring. We need mentor. Ako, I really listen to podcasts. I really listen to good public speakers. And I really listen to Bo Sanchez with his styles. I really listen to Arun Gogna with his style. I really listen to podcast of Brian Tracy. Ganun yun. Kaya, ang ganda mamaya. Kasi, there is an architect also, expert na on the field, marami ng karanasan. So marami siyang mga testimonies na maibibigay based from what he has also learned in the field. So maganda po yun. Pero ang problema nitong wheelbarrow is yung mentoring. Bakit? You need a pusher. You need someone to push you. Try harder. Okay? Pero ang problema sa'yo, ayaw mong pupush kasi feeling mo, mas magaling ka pa sa nagpupush sa'yo. Or ayaw mong pupush kasi pinupush ka niya sa right, gusto mo sa left. Dapat naman yung nagpupush, alam din niya, yung ano rin ang gusto mo. Parang gano'n. Para at least, hashtag one direction. Oh, ulitin natin. Hashtag one direction. Pero ang problema, kapag magaling na, may sungay na. So, ayaw niyo magpupush because he believes that he is actually better than the one pushing him. Oh, again, balikan natin dito. Ah. Humility is still the most powerful traits of all. And yung pinaka-last natin dito ay gold watch. Importante yung time. Time actually is the key elements in our maturity. Alright, huwag tayong magmadali. Chill lang, relax lang. You have to enjoy chasing our dreams. Although, hindi ko sinasabing do not chase your dreams. Gusto ko nga mag-aspire ka talaga eh, to become better. Diba, paulit-ulit yung sinasabi. But you really have to have fun. You really have to enjoy. Dapat ini-enjoy yan. Like parang ako, right now, I'm enjoying. It's just like talking to my mother. It's like talking to my friends. Ganun dapat. Yung parang di ka napapagod. Alright? Pag di ka napapagod, you can actually do the talks for 4 hours na hindi ka pagod at meron ka pang energy. Alright? So moving on, ano ba talaga sir yung mga 8 traits to be great? Ano dapat yung meron ako? Una, passion. I love what I do. Promise, I love to talk. I just don't know. Kung natutulog ako, nagsasalita pa rin ako. Pero promise, ito talaga yung gusto kong gawin. I discovered my core gift. When I was in high school, I loved doing public speaking. I was a winner in most debate most debate in the class, and I actually am also a winner of extemporaneous speech. Talagang speaking, talagang, it's really more of the, I really want to inspire a lot of people, especially the young people of today. So passion, I'm so passionate. I don't know if you can feel that one, but there's an energy in it. Nanggagaling siya sa puso, hindi kasi siya napipake. So passion, I love talking. I love inspiring people, all right? And you have to love what you do. Mahalin mo talaga yung ginagawa mo. Cliche as it may sound, you've heard it from a lot of people, pero please, maniwala ka. You have to love what you do. You really have to have that burning desire to what you do. Kailangan mahal mo yan. Palagi nating naririnig kanina. Kanina minention ko na ulit, it is not what you do, it is how much love you put to what you do. But when you say love, it is the burning love to what you do. O, familiar na kayo dyan. Kilalang-kilala na yan. A very popular Hollywood actor, Russell Crowe, Oscar-winning actor, said, "The bottom line is, I love the actual job of acting. I have great passion for it." Manny Pacquiao, my goodness, he does not want to retire from boxing because he loves boxing. Alright? Ibig sabihin, kung ano talaga yung core mo, you will die definitely loving it. Alright? And ako siguro, until the end of time, I will still speak. Maybe in my dying bed, I will still speak. I will still give inspiration. Okay? Successful people, do it for love, not for money. If, I am not saying you don't need money, do not get me wrong. What I'm saying is, do it for love, not for money. Ulitin ko lang po, if you are passionate in anything that you want to do, do it for love, not for money. Come on, Sir Santi, you don't need money. I know you need money, pero gusto ko lang pong sabihin na si Bill Gates po, of course, we know him, the chairman of Microsoft, and Paul, his business partner, Paul and Bill Gates, we never thought we would make much money. We just love writing software. Ulitin ko lang po, and that's boom! Bingo! O, anong sinabi ni Bill Gates, yung chairman of Microsoft? Ang sabi niya, Paul, his business partner, and him, we never thought we would make much money. We just love writing software. So the bottom line is passion. It's really loving what you do. Alright? And the cruel reality in the world is embrace yourself and be hooked. Because if you do it for love, the money comes anyway. I was once a speaker who's just receiving a pro bono. Ibig sabihin puro libre, 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 libre. But once I already developed a name in me, may pangalan na. So hindi na siya free. Alam mo yun, nag-gets niyo ako. If the cruel thing in the world is if you do it for love, the money comes anyway. Diba po? But ito yung pinakamaganda, okay? Ito yung pinakamaganda. If you are passionate to what you do, the money comes anyway. Perfect. Okay, darating at darating pa rin yung pera. That's the number one. You have to develop that passion in you, that burning desire to what you do. Pangalawa po is work really hard. Na-mention ko na kanina yan, work, hashtag work. Yung una nating hashtag is passion. Paki-hashtag po yan ha, kung meron kayong mga takeaway later. And na pangalawa po is hashtag work. So ano po itong work? All successful people work really hard. Ulitin na, all successful people work really hard. I did not have a silver platter in my, di ba? Ibig sabihin, pinaghirapan ko to, yung pangalan ko, yung Santaner Iray, yung Santi Iray, pinaghirapan yan. Hindi naman yan agad-agaran binigay agad. I work hard for it. And familiar kayo dito, doko, sa mga kababaihan natin, Martha Stewart, to empower women also na nasa architecture field, na mga babae. Si Martha Stewart, a homemaking guru, ano ang sabi niya? I am a real hard worker. I work, work, and work all the time. Imagine yung work, work, work niya, tatlong beses binanggit. I am a real hard worker. I work and work and work all the time. Hard work. Pinaka-importante. Pero, binago naman ito. At sino naman ito? Siyempre, isa din siyang successful na billionaire. He's a media tycoon. Sabi ni Rupert Murdoch, it's all hard work. Nothing comes easy. But, okay, sabi ni Martha Stewart, hard work. Pero sabi ni Rupert Murdoch, you really have fun. You should have a lot of fun doing what you do. Napakaganda na naman. So, ibig sabihin, hindi ka lang dapat workaholic. You should be workaholic. So our hashtag today is workaholic. Anong ibig sabihin ng workaholic? Workaholic means loving and having fun to what you do. It's not just loving, but having fun to what you do. Because successful people have fun working. take it from me. I love this. I love what I do. I love delivering speeches. This is me. This is who really I am. All right. And I am successful. Maybe I can assess myself. I am successful in motivating other people. I have fun working. I have really fun working and delivering this talk. All right. Successful people are not workaholics. They are workaholics. And the father of success, lagi niyong tatandaan, is hard work. It is correct. But the mother of success is integrity. You have to develop that kind of a name in you to have that integrity. Kasi nga, hardworking ka nga, pero wala ka namang integridad. Sayang din po. Number 3, trait to be great is focus. You really have to focus on one thing, all right? Of course, Norman Jewison, an Oscar-winning filmmaker, said, I think it all has to do with focusing yourself to one thing and one thing only. Okay, ito yung gusto mo eh. Ito yung goal mo. Set mo yung goal mo na yan. And work hard for it. And have fun working. Okay? I-enjoy mo yan. Some people Some people don't focus and they dabble. Alright? Ibig sabihin, ang dami nilang gustong gawin. Kanina minention ko, that is a Christmas light kind of personality or a bar lights kind of personality. But it's okay. Dami mong gustong gawin. It's okay to get started. Okay? But you need to focus on one thing and one thing only. Sa umpisa, yes, ang dami mong gustong gawin, pero nagkaroon ka na ng realization and you want to focus yourself to what you can do. Number 4, because I think I'm running out of time, is push. You really have to push yourself really hard. Great people just keep pushing themselves. All right? Ulitin natin. Great people just keep pushing themselves. Very familiar man, Richard Branson, the founder of Virgin Records and Airlines. Sabi niya, whatever you're doing in life, just push yourself to the limits. All right? Whatever you're doing in life, just push yourself to the limits. Gary Valenciano, I've heard in one of his interviews, sinabi niya, I really am pushing myself really hard. Ibig sabihin sila, nagtitrain din yan. Or they push themselves to become good singers. Okay? So, sila din mismo, they push themselves. Are you shy? Push yourself anyway. Do you have self-doubt? Push yourself anyway. Kalaban mo sarili mo. Mahihain ka? Push yourself anyway. Do you have self-doubts? Nadududa ka sa sarili mo kung kaya mo? Push yourself anyway. Okay? I think you guys are also familiar with Goldie Hawn. So Goldie Hawn, an actress producer, said, I always had self-doubts. I wasn't good enough. I wasn't smart enough. I didn't think I'd make it. A lot of young people out there also. Some of them are really confident, but some of them are not. Some of them have self-doubts. Some of them think that they are not good enough. Some of them think that I am not smart enough. And some of them think that I will not make it. Kaya nga yung mga iniwan, parang tinanggap na nila sa sarili ko, kasalanan ko to kasi iniwan ako, hindi po ako sapat. No! You are more than enough. You are more than enough. So if you have self-doubt, if you think that you are not good enough, you are not smart enough, if you think that you're not gonna make it, whew! Alright, take it from Goldie Hawn. It's not easy to push yourself. That's why you need your mom to push you. Yes! Our mom is the number one pusher. Alright? Bakit po? Dati di naman siguro ako magaling kumanta, pero yung ay, magaling kang kumanta. Yes, yes! Kaya una talagang paasa sa buhay natin yung mga nanay natin eh. Di ba? Lagi talaga yung mga nanay natin, they're very supportive of what we want in life. Some of them may not be, but the really majority of the moms talaga are really very supportive. So find someone to push you. Talk to your mom and yan, dun ka kumuha ng inspiration. Okay? Sabi nga po ni Frank Cherry, a famous architect. Kailangan may kasama talaga to kasi this is our topic and I'm speaking, I think, to numbers of architects, maybe successful, maybe future architects, successful architects in the Philippines and the world, or the universe rather. Sabi niya ni Frank Cherry, my mother pushed me. Pero gusto ko lang sabihin, yes, meron po tayong pusher. Like halimbawa, yung mom natin, number one pusher, not number one cheerer natin, pero lagi nating tatandaan, it is you pa rin na magde-decide kasi you are the captain of your own ship. Ayan. So follow what you want, alright, and follow what you desire to do. Pero you need a pusher, alright? You need a pusher to push you. Find somebody to push you. ano yung mga ibang mga nagpo-push sa'yo para ma-challenge ka? Of course, yung challenges, yung goals, yung deadlines, yung self-discipline, and of course, yung competition. Challenges and opportunities. Sometimes yung mga challenges, akala natin, eto yung mga building blocks. No, they are opportunities. They are not threats. They are opportunities. Yung goals natin sa buhay, yung mga deadlines, yung self-discipline, and yung competition. Yeah, maganda yung competition para at least nagsistep up ka rin sa game mo. And just want to let everybody know that no matter how beautiful and handsome you are, just remember, baboons and gorillas also attract tourists, so stop boasting. Alright, kung magaling ka, sinabi ko kanina, magpakumbaba ka. So lagi mong tatandaan, kahit gaano ka pa kaganda at kagwapo, pagdating sa zoo, hindi ikaw ang pinapalakpakan, kundi ang unggoy at gorilla. Sila ang bida. So please, stop boasting. No matter how big and strong you are, you will not carry yourself to grave, so be humble. Humility is a key. No matter how tall you are, you can never see tomorrow, so be patient. No matter how light-skinned you are, you will always need light and darkness. Kasi gaano ka pa kaputi, gagamit ka pa rin ng flashlight sa dilim, so take caution. And no matter how rich and many cars you drive, you will always walk to your bed, so be content. Kahit gaano pa kadami yung kotse mo, maglalakad ka pa rin papunta sa higaan mo. Remember that church and mosque has 6 letters, and so Bible and Quran, both of these have 5 letters. Life has 4 letters, so does death. So for every death, there is life that will come. Hate has 4 letters, so does love. So kung parehong 4 na letra din pala yung love and hate, so why should you hate the person beside you when you can actually love the person beside you? Pareho lang din namang energy yan. Enemies has 7 letters, so does friends. Pareho silang 7 letra, so why should you make a lot of enemies when you can gather a lot of good friends? Lying has 5 letters, so does truth. Lying and truth, both of these words have 5 letters. Hurt has 4 letters, so does heal. So for every hurt, there's a heal to come. All right, and there's a healing to come. And negative has 8 letters, so does positive. So why should you think negative when you can think positive? Kung parehong 8 letra lang din naman. So this topic is about character building and improving your life skills. And believe me, failure is the beginning of success. Bakit mo naman nasabi yan, Sir Santi? Because both failure and success have 7 letters. And below and above, both of these words have 5 letters. Cry has 3 letters, so does joy. So for every crying moment, there is a joy waiting for you. Anger has 5 letters, so does happy. Why should you be angry when you can actually be happy? All right? Kasi yun yung building block eh. Kaya kung ikaw ay may galit, hindi ka magiging masaya. And 5 letters din yung right and wrong. So why should you settle with the wrong kung kaya naman natin dito sa right? And rich and poor has 4 letters. Fail and pass has 4 letters. Knowledge has 9 letters, so does ignorance. I hope this afternoon I was able to bring you knowledge, kasi naniniwala ako, lamang ang may alam. At kapag lamang ka, huwag ka lang man lalamang. All right? So ibig sabihin, my responsibility. And if you think it is your alarm clock that has waken you up this morning, try putting it beside a dead body and you will realize that it is the grace of God that woke you up today. Ulitin natin, kung iniisip mo yung alarm clock ang gumising sa'yo kanina, ilagay mo yan sa patay, tingnan mo kung magigising ang patay, and you will then realize that God is the writer of our own story. Yeah, all right? Pero there are different types of people in our lives, 'di ba? Na nakaka-apekto din doon sa ating traits, kasi sila din kasama natin, we revolve. Kasi no one is an island. So ito, may mga tao tayong nakaka-deal, and sino 'to yung mga not so good people in our lives? Unang uri ng tao are the ACD. Ano yung ACD? Always complaining and disagreeable. All right, mga toxins yan and vampires that will eat your energy as much as possible. If you cannot influence them to become better, at least you have to stay away from them. It is not that you are stopping to love them, but you are loving them from the distance. I love that. Okay, the happiest people don't have the best of everything. They just make the best of what they have. Perfect. And as you breathe right now, another person takes his last. So stop complaining and learn to live your life with what you have. A lot of people right now have been complaining about their lives, their miserable lives, but if you think about it, nakaka-survive naman, COVID-free pa rin. So there's a lot of reasons to celebrate life. And yung pangalawang uri ng tao po, the not-so-good around us, is the troublemaker. The TM, the troublemaker. Ito po yung mga chismoso at chismosa. Why? Because haters will broadcast your failure but whisper your success. Pasensya na. I really have to include this because social media is so powerful that kahit ang galing-galing na ng performance mo, ang dami pa rin thumbs down at ang dami pa rin haters. I just don't know. The hate culture is becoming so popular na lahat ng tao can give their own opinion and they are not really humane. And gusto ko lang sabihin sa inyo, the troublemaker, ito yung mga chismoso at chismosa, they are just there but please do not allow them to define you. You are more than your bashers, okay? So haters will broadcast your failure but whisper your success because some people cannot function without seeing the negativity in you because seeing you down will make them feel better. So do not allow other people to win. Diba? By seeing you down. By making you feel down. Okay? Ayan. And for those who gossip about you, yung chinichismis ka sa school kasi hindi mo pinakopya and many things, oh, ganito yung gawin mo. Gumanon ka at sabihin mas tao magchismis sa'yo, thank you for making me the center of your world. Oh, diba? Sikat ka. Ikaw ang bida sa kanya. And the next type of people is the emotional people. The EP or emotional people. Ito yung mga magkaibigan na may ganito pong mga script sa buhay. I'm sorry if I change, but you change too. Ito yung sinasabi niya, pasensya na kung nagbago ako, pero una kang nagbago. Oh, yung ganun-ganun. Alright, that's emotional people. Wow, mature people na dapat tayo. Okay? Okay, moving on. The AID, yung always in doubt. Always in doubt. Ang daming mga controllers, manipulative people, and if you doubt yourself, you can do it, then some people will manipulate you. Pero sabi ni Eleanor Roosevelt, nobody can hurt you without your permission. Bingo! Ulitin ko, nobody can hurt you without your permission. So whether it is love, whether it is about relationship, importante dyan is alam mo yung worth mo para hindi ka masaktan ng iba. Oh, next, the SOH or the Speaker of the House. Oh, siya na lang lagi ang nagsasalita. Oh, manipulative yan. Alright? Speaking with class, if I may tell you, is knowing what to say, alam dapat ang sasabihin, when to say it, kailan sasabihin, and when to stop, kailan hihinto. And the last type of people, not so good people in your life, is the FTC or the follow the crowd mentality. Tingnan mo naman to, oh, alam na niya dito sa crocodile, sabi niya, let's go, tapos sabi niya, okay, sunod-sunuran. Oh, wala na siyang sariling bait. It's easy to stand with the crowd, but it takes courage to stand alone. Okay? It's easy to stand with the crowd, but it takes courage to stand alone. But when you know that you are at the right, then kahit mag-isa ka lang, you can still battle if you believe that you are doing the right thing. Okay. And yung panglima po na traits to be great is ideas. Marami tayong mga ideas. One good idea has taken many people to the top. One good idea has taken many people to the top. Of course, classic example is Bill Gates founded the Microsoft. Sabi niya, I have a single idea. And he founded the first microcomputer software company. Ang galing mo. Kung may idea ka, hobby mo, oh, I have this idea. Oh, go for it. You should actually be creative in your ideas. Ang sabi nila, only artsy people are creative. No, in reality, everybody is creative. Alright, unleashing that creativity in you. Kailangan ma-discover mo yan. And Donald Trump, of course, hindi na po siya ngayon ang presidente ng Amerika. Pero I've learned also from him. Yes, yes. May mga lesson din siya. Alam mo, ang sabi ni Donald Trump, sabi niya, he is a real estate developer before he became the president, the 45th president of the United States. Sabi niya, deals are my art form. And when you define what is art, art is anything beautiful. At para sa kanya, deals is beautiful for him because it is an art. Ang galing. There's no magic in coming up with good ideas. Just listen to very simple things that everybody can do. Ulitin natin, di dapat ito yung parang, wow, kailangan ganito, kailangan virtual yung ideas, kailangan ganyan. That, hindi. Simple things that everybody can do. Yes, yan. Yung mga minsan, yung mga simple pa na mga idea, yun pa yung, wow, yun pala yun. Yan. So, anong gagawin? Be curious. Pag may mga bago, ano itong mga, of course, definitely not drugs. Alright, ngayon, magiging curious ka. No vice, okay? Yung mga technologies, yung mga gadgets, yung mga techniques, yung mga methodologies, you really have to be curious in it. Like, look around. kailangan talaga may matang lawin ka rin eh. Tinitingnan mo, ano ba to? Ganyan. What people would actually do. Something to that effect. Listen to people. Kaya nga, di ba meron tayong two ears? In listening, there is love. Pag kinumbine mo to, isang, yan. Yan at saka yan, combined together, it forms a heart shape. Promise. Dalawang ears, pag kinumbine mo together, it forms a heart shape. Kaya very powerful yung listening to people because in listening, there is love. And yung mga learnings mo, yung sulat mo, importante yan kasi binabalikan mo. Yung diary, I also do that. I have my own diary. I write what's my feeling, I write what's my frustration, and I write also my dreams. Yun. Minsan, I collect also pictures together with the write-up. And connect things. Kailangan i-connect mo yan. Ah, bakit kaya nangyari to sa akin? Ano ba yung connection ito sa nangyayari sa buhay ko? Ayan. And number 6 po na things to great traits to be great is you need to improve. Hashtag improve. Successful people are in continuous mission to improve themselves to be better or to get better. And how do you improve? Tatlong words. Alright, how do you improve? Tatlong words. Anong mga words to Sir Santi? Practice, practice, and practice. Ulitin ko. How do you improve? Practice, practice, and practice. How do I improve myself? Bago yung talk ko, I see myself in front of the mirror. I actually practice, practice, and practice. Yun. Yung lahat ng yung mga sinum up ko sa inyo are also my traits. That's why right now, I think I am great. Alright, kilala nyo na to. Oh, Tour de France. Okay, sa Lance Armstrong, 7-time Tour de France winner, sabi niya, the difference is that my team practices 12 months of the year, not 3 or 4. Imagine, 12 months of the year, magagaling na sila. Oh, di ba? 7-time Tour de France winner. Oh, pwede na yung pabanjing-banjing lang. Pero ang sabi niya, the difference is that my team practices 12 months of the year, not 3 or 4. And number 7, a trait to be great is serve. Successful people do not just serve themselves. They serve others something of value. When we say service, it is not just about pertaining to charity. It is about your skill. It is about your potential. Whatever is your potential, your skill, your talents, show it to the world. Let the world know that you have such kind of talent. Huwag kang madamot. So I just don't mean it the charity sense. What I meant about that is your product, your services, your business, anything that has something of value. And all successful billionaires have served themselves. Ulitin ko lang, all successful billionaires in their career, in their profession, yung mga artista, they also have served. All right? Successful people do not just serve themselves, they serve others something of value. When you allow other people to see your gift, to see your talent, that is service. Wag mong itago yan sa sarili mo. Show the world what you've got. Sam Walton, Walmart discount. Sam Walton ng Walmart. Okay? Imagine, he gave a lot of services. Bill Gates, di ba, sa software naman. Oh, meron na tayong IKEA furniture, okay, sa Philippines. So hopefully, let's see. Martha Stewart, lahat yan sila. Yung common denominator is they have given something of value. Their products, their services. Martha Stewart, America's first female self-made billionaire, sabi niya, I came to people with trusted information, useful information, valuable ideas, and products. And then after listening to people, then he offered that something of value. Ang galing. And number 8, yung 8 traits to be great, is persist. You have to persist through time because there really is no overnight success. Ulitin ko lang po. You have to persist through time because there really is no overnight success. You really have to work for it. And time is the most important element of success. Kilala nyo na to. Co-founder of Google. Alright? Sero, guro, meron na kayong idea dyan. Larry Page, the co-founder of Google, sabi niya, it takes a long time to do these things and a lot of success is just due to the amount of time you put into it. If you want to be an expert, focus on your core gift, on where you are good at. All right? Persist through crap. Ano to? Criticism. Say, maraming mga epal talaga. diba? Mga bashers, diba? So persist through your bashers or criticisms. Rejection, I've mentioned that earlier. Adversity or mga problema sa buhay. We can never choose our problem, but you can choose to move forward and smile even in the midst of your problem, because I believe that smile is the most powerful antidote to adversities in life. Because the meaning of smile is hashtag see miracles in life every day. Whatever it is that you are going through, smile. And prejudice, people will judge you. We are moving into the world. We are moving into this judgmental world. Pero, pag alam mo yung sarili mo, you are not affected. All right? Persist through failure, because all successful people have failed at first. Ulitin ko lang, persist through failure, because all successful people failed at first. Of course, of the Universal Studio, all right? The Senior Vice President, Robert Ward, you really have to persist because it won't be easy and there will be failure. Ulitin ko lang, hindi madali, pero it's all worth it. Hindi madali, but it's all worth it. Okay? And to wrap up my presentation for today, because I was just given 45 minutes or close to 1 hour, I want you to think three animals. O, gusto ko mag-isip ka ng favorite three animals mo. All right, you have to rank them in order at your mind, or you can actually list that down. So ano ang pinakauna mong favorite, pangalawa mong favorite, at pangatlo mong favorite, and then describe it in your mind if you don't have a pen or paper. Kasi sana sasabihin ko you have to have your pen and paper and write it down. But if you have a photographic memory, so just like allow your mind to think about it. So three of your most favorite animals. So ano yung una mong, and then write your characteristics. So yung favorite animal mo, if you have a pet, you have a pet dog, if you have a dog, then syempre yung number one mo. Cat naman yung pangalawa mo, ganyan. So three favorite animals. And after listing those favorite animals and their characteristics or attributes, I have to give the definition of what you have ranked. Okay? So the first attribute on your listed first beloved animal is how do people see or observe you. So kung ang nilista mo dyan ay dog, the characteristic and of the dog that you wrote is friendly, then the attributes on your listed first beloved animal is how do people see or observe you. So you are friendly. Congratulations. All right? And then yung pangalawa mong nilagay na favorite mong animal is cat. The second one is how you think people see or observe you. Look at this. Huh? The second one is how you think. Yung iniisip mo kung ano ang iniisip ng ibang tao tungkol sa'yo. Lagi mong tatandaan that how you see yourself may not be how other people see you. Okay, and yung pangatlo mong sinulat ay ahas. Okay, and yung attribute na nilagay mo sa ahas ay mga agaw. Okay, or peste. And yung ahas po is how and what you actually are. But if you wrote in their bird, then that's how you are. How you really are. And sometimes the best and the hardest, the question that you have to ask yourself is, who am I? Because not all people would know who they really are until they have discovered themselves. You really have to discover yourself of who you really are. Okay? And of course, number two, put the five following animals in the order of your preference. O, anong paborito mo dyan? Cow, tiger, sheep, horse, or pig? So what's your favorite? Choose one. All right? Ulitin ko lang. Ano yung favorite mo among these five animals? Is it cow, tiger, sheep, horse, or pig? All right? Okay. Since mabilisan tayo, kung yung favorite mo ay cow, your choices describe your priority in life. Pag cow ang pinili or baka, that describes your career. So your priority is your career. Wow, galing. So kung sa architecture, okay, so talagang yun talaga yung ano mo, I want this, I want to chase this. So that's your plan. Oh, ayaw mo makasagabal dyan. So wala boyfriend muna. Diretso-diretso ka. Okay, so that's your priority. And kung tiger naman yung sinulat mo na favorite mo, your priority right now is how to lessen your pride and ego. So that's also good for starting the 2021. And yung pinili mo ay sheep. That's your priority in life. And ang definition ng sheep, I love. Wow, congratulations. That's finding your one true love. It can be anything. It can be your career also. You love your career. You love your parents. And you love romantically your boyfriend or your girlfriend. And horse. Sa horse naman, your choice of a horse describes your priority, and that is your family. Oy, gustong patunayan yung best niya. Makagraduate, makapasa, and magkaroon ng magandang trabaho, at maging inspirasyon sa iba para sa pamilya. Perfect! And yung last po ay pig. Alright? And you might be thinking it's about food, but no. Alright. It pertains to money. Okay. So ano itong mga priority natin sa buhay? Career, pride, love, family, money. These are the driving forces that will actually make us better people in our career. Ang galing no, ayun mo, career, pride, love, family, and of course, money. Alright, and moving on. Write one or two words, attribute or adjective that describes each one of the following. Like halimbawa yung dog, ano yung kanyang attribute or kanyang description or adjective that you can put. Cat, rat, coffee, and then C. So, sa dog, di ba, we mentioned friendly, cat, maybe domesticated or alagain. Rat, pestering yung rat eh. Coffee, maybe pampagising. And sea or dagat, maybe kalmado. Alright, maybe that's what you think about. But if it's different from what I think, then it's okay. Because that's basically your story. Alright? And Sir Santi, ano yung description naman pag pinili ko ay yung attribute ng dog ay friendly? Okay, pag sa dog po, implies your own personality. So you are friendly. Alright? Sa cat naman, na domesticated, that's the personality of your partner or your boyfriend or would-be partner in the future. And rat, alright? Peste, that's the personality of your enemy. And yung description mo sa kape ay pampagising, that's how you view your sex life. Pero syempre, unahin muna yung career. Okay? And yung dagat or sea, that's actually your life right now. It implies your right life right now. So as you are talking to me and your answer is kalmado, malalim, that's basically your right life right now. And I would like to congratulate you because this is so tricky. Hindi ako nag-provide ng pictures because I don't want you to have that opinion or maging pre-opinionated yung discussion. Kaya dapat nang gagaling sa'yo. Medyo mabilis lang yung facing natin because I'm just given a very limited time. Pero kapag nakuha niyo yun, then you really have something to take home. And think of someone you know and also knows you may be important to you that you can relate to the following colors. So bawat isang kulay, isang tao lang. It can be generic. Halimbawa, sa yellow, paborito ng nanay mo, put your mom. Sa orange naman yung tatay mo, put your dad. Sa red naman, yung boyfriend mo, put your boyfriend. Sa white naman, your best friend mo, put your best friend. And yung green, maybe yung classmate mo. Ayan. Okay, so dan sa bawat kulay, kailangan maglagay ng isang tao na close sa'yo na kilala mo at kilala ka rin. Okay? And I have to give the impression na. Okay, your choice means kapag yellow, nilagay mo doon yung tatay mo or yung nanay mo, someone you will never forget. Ang galing. Sa orange naman, nilagay mo dyan yung kaibigan mo, someone you consider your true friend. Doon naman sa red, nilagay mo yung boyfriend mo, someone you really love. Congratulations. Kasi pag nilagay mo dyan yung ex mo, lagot ka mamaya, mag-aaway kayo. If you put in, sa white naman, halimbawa, nilagay mo dyan yung tita mo, so your twin soul. And sa green naman, pag nilagay mo dyan yung lolo mo, someone you will remember for the rest of your life. Alright? Something to take home today or this afternoon. And last question po. Before I finally end my talk, what is your favorite number and favorite day of the week? Just write it down. What is your favorite number and favorite day of the week? And if you were able to write already your favorite number and favorite day of the week, then this is my impression. There are 24/7 in a day, and every day is to be celebrated with hope because at the end of the day, your real treasure is not your money in the bank. It is not your power, but how good you are in building good relationship. And that is the most important trait that defines a successful person. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a good afternoon.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Santi, for that very inspiring lecture. Talaga naman pong sobrang fruitful ng inyong pong naging talk. As in, kami po ay na-motivate sa lahat po ng inyong mga points na i-share. And siguro po, isdadahin ko po ito, siguro personally, hanggang sa aking career, hanggang sa pagtanda, dahil sobrang makakatulong talaga ito sa ating life. And also, it is really important for us youth to develop basic life skills at an early age because it will surely come in handy in the future. And katulad nga po ng sabi niyo kanina, it is not daily for us college students to get to talk about this topic. So, we are greatly honored po to learn from a professional like you po. Siguro, Sir Santi, yung takeaway ko po sa inyo is yung about sa comfort zone, yung pag-step out natin sa ating comfort zone. Kasi what could have been a great thing sana was hindered just because we are afraid to get out of our comfort zone. So, marami pang opportunities na meron tayo sa outside of our comfort zone na pwede nating ipave para mas matuto pa tayo. And never stop learning, of course. Rejection is okay. And kailangan natin din tandaan na hindi naman po lahat is alam na natin or kaya na natin. Diba po? And also, yung sinabi nyo po na choose people who choose you. Wow. Yun, kasi before, I have friends na sobrang dami na parang hindi naman sila nakakatulong sa life ko. And natuto po akong mag-select ng mga friends na talagang nakakatulong po sa akin and ako din po sa kanila. It is important na may correct or right persons po na tutulong po para sa inyo. Ayun po. At talagang character improvement po talaga ang ang goal natin today, sir. Maraming salamat po. Partner, naka-mute ka yata?
Oh, sorry. Ayan. That's right, partner. Also, it is essential for us youth to learn these basic life skills for us to be able to help ourselves as well as the people around us. And yung sa akin naman po, yung takeaway ko po sa discussion nyo is age is just a number po. And kasi I want to share lang po na first year pa lang po ako pero I'm already 23 years old po. Kasi nag-stop po ako nung elementary and habang natagal po nare-realize ko na age is just a number and yung schooling and yung pag-aaral po is hindi naman po siya paunahan. As long as masaya ka na ginagawa mo to and wala ka pong masawang ginagawa and tinatapakan na tao, continue po and never stop learning.
Nakatutuwa kami na malaman yan sa'yo, Prince. Totoo na ang schooling is not a competition naman and we hope na maging successful ka sa studies mo together with the Kaup buddy.
Thank you po.
Yes. Sir Santi, siguro po we have a question. Let's begin na ba, Prince, partner?
Yes. I think it's time for us to entertain some of our viewers' queries. We have them. This one is from Ronel Repil po. What to do if you feel burnt out already?
Ayan, wow. Ayan. San ba tong burnout na to? Sa love life ba to? Or sa pag-aaral? So, hindi niya naklaro. Okay, anyway, lagi nating tatandaan, and we always hear this, you don't have to quit, but you have to rest. Ulitin ko lang, you don't have to quit, but you have to rest. You have to listen to your body. You have to listen to your mind. Okay? So pag yung mind mo nagsasabi na stop overthinking, you listen to it. Your body is telling you that you need to rest. You really have to rest. Kasi otherwise, pag hindi mo pinakinggan yung mind mo, yung katawan mo, yung emotions mo, then you will definitely experience the burnout. At kahit ano pa man yung gagawin mo, you are not motivated to do it because you are already burnout. Self-care is the most important thing you can offer to yourself. Pamper yourself. Importante yan. Right? Unahin mo muna yung sarili mo. Alright? Kasi pag okay ka na, pag you are back already on track, then it will be easier for you to do whatever you want.
Ayan. Thank you so much po, Sir Santi. Ayan, sabi nga ni Sir, work hard but rest well too. Ayan.
Yes, yes.
So next question, we have Christiana Lois. What if there is something you really want to do but you don't know how to do it? So you don't know where to start.
Wow, that's why it is important to have a mentor. All right. So, ibig sabihin, hindi ka makapag-initiate yourself. Diba? So, kay importante yung mga benchmarks. Importante yung mga tao na already are experienced in that field. So, you get something from them. And then, ikaw, you have to take note also. Ito yung mga areas na to. Sinabi ko kanina, what may work for them may not actually work for you. But at least you have taken those things and you actually have tried. Kasi nga, dapat kumawala tayo dun sa mga what-ifs. Diba? You don't know what to do with, but you wanted to start. So how can you start? You have to listen to those people who already have started and you already are successful in that field. In that way, there is already an opportunity for you to start whatever it is that you want to do. So mentorship, mentoring is really very important. And yung pakikinig, importante yun eh. Yung pakikinig. And hindi tayo dapat natatakot magtanong. Di ba? Meron nga po, hindi naman sila sponsor, pero huwag kang mahihiyang magtanong. Alam na. Di ba? Sa isang brand. So, huwag tayong matatakot magtanong kasi hindi mo nga alam paano magsimula eh. So, you really have to ask from the experts on how to start. Kasi may mga tao naman na hindi madamot para ikaw ay turuan.
Thank you so much again po, Sir Sante. And I hope nasagot po yung tanong mo, Miss Christina Lois. And for our last question, We have from Jando. What to do if you're feeling unmotivated even though the deadlines are coming near?
Wow, okay. I like that. I-relate ko yung tanong sa sarili ko. Kasi diba, I am a motivational speaker. So sir, meron bang mga pagkakataon that you are not motivated to do a motivational talk? Ayan. Parang inano ko lang ha, parang inirelate ko lang sa sarili ko para mas marelate mo rin yung kasagutan dito sa tanong mo. So, yes, dumarating sa buhay ng tao, like me, I am a motivational speaker, and dumarating din sa punto that I am not motivated to do the motivational talk. Kaya kailangan talaga mag-recharge. Ayun. I-recharge mo yung sarili mo, hahanapin mo kung saan mo huhugutin doon yung drive mo. Kasi hinahanap yan. There is this meron siyang point in our sa sarili kasi natin, meron siyang parang recharge, 'di ba? May charge and then recharge. So pag nalobat ka na, pwede mo naman siyang i-recharge. 'Yun yung ibig kong sabihin. Kasi the reason why you are not motivated to meet the deadline is because ang dami mo nang mga ginawa that has made you also feel na masyado nang na-drain ka o na-drain out ka na. So even though malapit na yung deadline, but you are not actually motivated to beat the deadline. So doon, kailangan ma-recharge. Hahanapin mo ulit yun. Parang pin siya, hanapin mo doon sa pinaka-core mo para at least ma-recalibrate mo, ma-re-access mo ulit, ma-reassess mo ulit kung yung ginagawa ko na to na malapit na yung deadline, what is it for me? Kailangan masagot mo sa sarili mo yan. What is it for me? Because yung deadline na hinahanap mo, and if you have discovered that that means the world to you, then that drive will come back. And that yung deadline na hinahabol mo, magagawa mo na ulit yun. Kasi nga yung tanong na sagot mo, what is it for me? And if you have answered it, this means the world to me, then automatically, nahanap mo na yung pin na yun para mag-recharge ka ulit. We need to keep on recharging ourselves. Yun talaga yung pinaka-key. Like parang sa akin, kailangan recharge, recharge, and recharge. Parang yung cellphone, di ba? Pag lowbat na siya, i-recharge mo para gumana. Ganyan din tayo mga tao. We have to keep on recharging ourselves.
Yes. Ayan. Thank you for that wonderful answer, Sir Santi.
And I think
may isa pa pong pahabol na question from Miss Rika Elaine. What to do if you feel like you're always running out of time, especially with tons of deadlines to meet?
Yes, thank you for reminding me. parang akong ako yan. Lagi kong iniisip, sabi ko, ano ba yan? Dami kong ginagawa. Parang kulang na kulang yung oras ko. Come on. You really have to cite your priorities. Ibig sabihin, kailangan may to-do list ka. Kailangan ilalagay mo doon. Meron kasing urgent but not a priority. Meron ding priority but not urgent. Merong necessary but not a priority. Meron ding priority but not necessary. So, kailangan ma-check mo doon. Ibig sabihin, eto ba ay urgent, eto ba ay priority, at eto ba ay necessary. You actually need to have a to-do list and you really have to click in kung saan sila nakalagay. So, sila ba ay urgent, kung sila ba ay necessary, kung sila ba ay priority. Alright? So, pag sila ay urgent, necessary, and priority, lalagay mo yun sa unahan. Kasi tayo, pag may dumating na, halimbawa, may late na dumating, mas inuuna pa natin yun, natabunan tuloy yung mga nauna. Ayun. So, kailangan meron kang to-do list. Tapos, ika-characterize, parang i-distinguish mo siya whether ito ba ay priority, ito ba ay necessary, or ito ba ay urgent. Kasi may mga bagay naman na prioritize mo, pero di naman sila necessary and urgent. Sayang yung oras mo. Diba? Dapat nauna mo na yung mga priority, necessary, and then urgent. Pero mas inuna mo, yung priority mo, di ba? Pero di naman necessary. Good. Ganun yun. So dapat, piliin mo yung taong pinapriority ka.
Tama. Ayan, thank you po ulit. And thank you for answering the questions of our live viewers. And I think we've covered and answered all your questions. Yes. So once again...
Yes. So, Santi, thank you so much po for passionately answering the questions of our live viewers. Sa questions po ng iba nating live viewers, sir, baka meron po kayong social media platforms na pwede po nating ma-reach kayo if may mga nais pang
motivate. Sure. You can follow me on my page, yung Philippines Needs More Heroes.
Noted on that, sir. So, sa ating mga live viewers na kailangan pa ng motivational talks from sir sa mga panahon na nangangailangan tayo, you can reach po sa social media ni sir.
Philippines Needs More Heroes and Santi Says. Okay, Santi Says, yung may personal motivational blog.
Okay, yeah. Po sir.
Thank you very much for lending us your time and effort, Sir Santaner Tendranes Iray, and for sharing with us your kind words of wisdom that would certainly be beneficial for our life skills. At this point, we would like to give you this certificate of appreciation for being with us virtually today. This certificate of appreciation is hereby presented to Mr. Santaner Tendrares Iray for imparting their knowledge and insight as a guest speaker of Arkitekturo, an online lecture series held this 10th day of January 2021 as part of the Project Tap via YouTube live stream. Together, let's take a step forward. Signed by Acting Student Council Vice President and Event Head Daniel Angeli G. Pastrano, Acting Student Council President Tricia Danica L. Belizar, and Project TAP Head Acting Student Council Auditor Ezekiel Joshua A. Punsalan.
Thank you po once again, Sir Santi, and we hope to meet you po in person soon if maging okay na po ang situation for similar seminars like this. Thank you po for getting this invitation.
Thank you for inviting me. Maraming salamat. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you po.
Ayan, so talaga namang nakakabusog ang naging talk ni Sir Santi sa motivation. Sobrang dami niyang naibigay na words of encouragement. Actually, sobrang dami. Parang lahat yun gusto kong sundin. Alam mo yun? Ikaw ba, partner? Nakakatuwa ba ang naging talk ni Sir para sa'yo?
Sobra, partner. Sobrang nakaka-motivate niya. And I know na marami ring na-motivate sa ating mga live viewers.
Alright. So, once again, guys, if you want more of webinars like these, please don't forget to like our official Facebook page. It's PLM Kaup Student Council. And follow us on Twitter and Instagram. It's at @KaupSCOfficial. And of course, support our One View, One Step Forward campaign by watching and subscribing our videos here on YouTube. Indeed, that was a very great talk. So now, sa ating mga live viewers, kamusta ba kayo? Nandiyan pa ba kayo? Let's loosen up a bit naman dahil we will be having a mini icebreaker. Ayan. I-ready na lang po natin ang inyong mga keyboards. Sa comment section, dyan po tayo maghahanap na magiging winners because this game is called Guess That Song Right. Ayan, of course, this is sponsored by Boujee Shop M&L. Once again, thank you so much to our sponsors for today's episode, Boujee Shop MNL and Sweet Hangover. Alright, so ready na po ba ang ating live viewers?
Ayan, ready na silang lahat.
Okay, okay. So our ang mechanics lang naman ng Guess That Wrong, That Song Right Challenge na ito ay we will be flashing sa screen sa jumbled letters ng song title ng isang song. And all you have to do is, of course, guess the song title and the artist. Okay, reminder, pakilagay din sa comment ang artist. So ganito yung magiging format po ng comment ninyo. Song title and then artist. And sa baba siguro is pakitype na ngayon pa lang ang inyong name and your block para madali naming ma-verify if kayo nga ang nanalo sa item na iyon. Alright, nakuha po ba ng ating mga live viewers? Ayan, partner, excited ka na ba sa mga magiging game natin ngayon?
Yes. Mukhang magkakaroon ng keyboard warriors sa ating comment section.
That is right. Ngayon, muli ay maraming salamat sa ating sponsors for today. It's Boujee Shop MNL and it's Sweet Hangover. Kindly check their Instagram and Facebook page to know more about their promising products. Alright, so magsisimula na tayo sa round 1 ng ating Guess the Song Title Challenge. Very
but
easy
before,
to, yes?
But before that, we will have our officers in charge to check on who will be the first one to comment on the correct answer. For this round, we will pick 4 winners of shop voucher and 1 winner of sunglasses from Boujee Shop MNL. Thank you once again to our sponsors. So, are you ready, guys? Alright.
Ready na ako. Pero syempre, hindi ako pwedeng sumali.
Hindi tayo sayang. Sayang yung prizes.
Also, remind din pala natin na kapag kayo ang napili sa isang item is paki-screenshot ang screen na lumabas ang inyong name para po maging proof of claiming ninyo. Okay? Yes.
Alright. For the first song, Roll VTR.
Okay, ayan, ito na po ang una nating item.
Ayan, makikita nyo sa ano sa ating mga screen ang word na Wheatrester, H-T-E-R-S-T-S. So again, comment your answer in the comment section.
Medyo mahirap to ah. 3 words ba to partner? 3 words?
Yes, 3 words siya, partner.
Alright, so song title and by yung artist ng kantang iyon and include your name and your block. Alright, so feeling ko ang song na to ay char, hindi pwede sabihin.
Again, title of the song, artist, name and block.
Ang mapipili sa item na to ay magkakaroon ng shop voucher from Boujee Shop MNL. And then the rest is magkakaroon naman ng sunglasses, also courtesy of them.
Yes. Ayan. Alright. Nasagot.
Ngayon po ay nakaabang ang ating alright.
Alright. So we have a winner. And our winner is John Neil Mozol. So that's Rewrite the Stars by Zac Efron and Zendaya. Again, congratulations to John Neil Mozol. Don't forget to screenshot this timestamp and message our Facebook page.
Alright, congratulations, Mr. Mozol. And of course, alam mo ba, partner, favorite ko talaga yung kantang yan.
True,
okay,
partner.
So let's move on sa next item. Next song, we have 2 words. I think this is 2 words. Makikita naman natin sa spacing, meron tayong 2 words na song title. Ano kaya ang song title na ito at sino ang artist nito? Please include also your name and your block para mas ma-verify namin later on kung kayo talaga ang naging winner ng song na ito. Ayan, so may nakapag-comment.
Hello, guys.
Medyo challenging ba itong item na ito? Ayan, nakita ko sa comment si Mr. John Neil Mozol. Thank you so much rin and hindi ka na pwedeng sumala sa mga susunod nating songs. Yes. Ayan, ikaw makakatanggap ng una nating shop voucher. Ayan, wala pa ba nakakahula ng song na ito? Alright, very, eto na po, may napili na po ang ating tech. Congratulations, Miss Isabel Manyang Lung, the scientist by Coldplay, according to her. Tama po ba? Nobody said it was easy. It's such a shame. That is right, this is the scientist by Coldplay, Miss Isabel Manyang Lung. Paki-screenshot na lang po itong timestamp na ito para maging proof of claiming ninyo later on. Alright, let's proceed with the next item.
So for the next item, we have only one word and dranikag.
Parang dranikag, no? Parang totoong word siya pero hindi. So ang title yan, mga Mars, so paki-comment na lang kung ano ang title nito and the artist. Ayan, very challenging. Alright, may wala pa ba nakakahula? Para sa ating mga officers in charge, nagbabantay po sila para mahanap kung sino ang unang makakomment ng tamang answer. Once again, thank you so much to our sponsor, Boujee Shop MNL and Sweet Hangover. Alright.
Ayan, may nanalo na. So, congratulations to Ian Gabriel Padua. I knew you, hand under my sweatshirt, baby, kiss it better, right? And then I felt like I was. Yes, and that is Cardigan by Taylor Swift. Again, congratulations to our winner.
Congratulations, Mr. Padua. Pa-screenshot na lang nitong nananalo ka and claim natin later. Alright, for the next item. Reminder lang guys, meron tayong 5 items for this round ha. Alright, ito naman ang next to. Makita natin 2 words po ito na English, international song. So ayan, pakihulaan naman po kung sino ang kumanta ng song na ito. Please kindly include na rin ang inyong name and then block para mas madali naming ma-verify kung kayo nga ang magme-message kay FB page later. Alright. Medyo challenging to, partner. Alam mo ba itong kantang to?
Parang hindi. Kasi ang hirap niya i-assemble.
Oo, true. Very challenging ang magiging labanan. Alright, may napili na po ba? Alright, si Miss Nicole Ann. Right? Yan. Si Miss Nicole Ann, congratulations. Tama po ang inyong answer. This is Nobody Else by Lainey. Would you lend a hand to me if I needed help? Would you keep... Yes, that is right. Congratulations, Miss Nicole Ann. And i-claim mo na lang yung prize mo later.
So for our last item for this first round. Ayan, as you can see, we have 2 words here. Aminobe. Aminobe.
Baka may medyo sa title. Very challenging pala siya.
Yes, partner.
Mukhang medyo nag-iisip ng very matagal ang ating mga live viewers para makuha.
Go guys, sayang ang sunglasses.
Kayang-kaya niyo po iyan. Yes, ang tama ka dyan, partner. Ang mananalo ng item nito is magkakaroon ng sunglasses from Boujee Shop MNL. Once again, thank you so much to our sponsors, Boujee Shop MNL and Sweet Hangover. Don't forget to check out their Facebook page and Instagram. It's at Boujee.shopmnl and at Sweet Hangover. Alright, wala pa bang nakakahula ng item na ito?
Mukhang wala pa, partner.
Pwede ba tayo magbigay ng ng very, very... Alright!
Ayan. So...
Alright, sino po ba talaga? Ayan.
So, we have a winner, Miss Alian, Kiara, and Tera.
Congratulations, Miss Alian. Is this the real life? Is this
just fantasy? Caught in... Yes, that is Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen. Again, congratulations to Miss Entera. And don't forget to screenshot this timestamp and message our Facebook page.
Alright, that's it for round 1 sa mga ating live viewers. So, let's continue this webinar na po. Okay, again, for the winners of the first round of our Guess That Song Right Challenge, kindly message our FB page later after the webinar together with a screenshot of your proof of winning po, okay? Again, don't forget to like our FB page. It's PLM Kaup Student Council. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram. It's at Kaup SC Official. And you can tweet us with the hashtag Arkitekturo underscore F3. And also, don't forget to subscribe and watch our videos to support the One View, One Step campaign of our Student Council. Alright, so let's continue na po.
Once again, thank you to Boujee Shop, MNL, and Sweet Hangover for sponsoring today's episode. Okay, so let's get right into our second talk. It is an honor to introduce to you our second guest speaker. He graduated from Pamantasan na Lungsod ng Maynila with a degree of Bachelor of Science in Architecture. Studied Master of Arts in Urban and Regional Residency at the University of the Philippines, Diliman. He is a registered architect with more than 20 years of working experience. He is currently the operations manager of CM2 Constructs Incorporated. He also worked for Federal Land Incorporated as the design manager for commercial projects, Technical Incorporated in SMEDD Corporation, JCDS2DZYN, and Architectural Services. Also witness his capabilities as the principal architect under their supervision. He also worked for Empire East Land Holdings Incorporated as a customer care technical assistant. He was also a full-time faculty member of the College of Architecture and Urban Planning at the Pamantasan na Lungsod ng Maynila from 2004 to 2007. Let us present the grandest of our applauses and welcome Architect John Christopher D. Sakdalan II.
Good afternoon, Architect.
Good afternoon. Okay, thank you for that introduction. Medyo highfalutin words yun.
Okay, sir, anyway. You can take the floor na po to begin with your presentation. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, thank you guys, Prince and Anjali. Okay. I'll be discussing about design management, no? So, karamihan ata rito mga arkitekto, mga architecture student, I don't know kung may mga engineering. So, I'll be discussing about this design management na it was introduced long time ago pero hindi natin alam na meron na pala. Na miski hindi pa ako napapanganak, meron na pala nito. So, I'll be sharing my screen for my presentation. Okay, can you see my presentation? Hello?
Yes po, Architect, nakikita po natin.
Okay. Again, I'm Architect John Christopher Sakdalan II. I'm a design management practitioner and a registered architect since 1998. So medyo matanda na rin. So I've been practicing design management since 2004. When I was in Robinson's Land as a project manager. So without further ado, I'll be proceeding with my presentation. So what are the objectives of this webinar? First, to understand the value and relevance of design management. Second is to identify the importance and purpose of engaging on design management. Third, to know the differences and similarities of design management with other design other management skills and practices. And fourth, to apply design management techniques and innovation in all projects. So this will be our outline. So we'll be defining words. We'll be discussing also the objectives of design management, its history and evolution, value and relevance, differences and similarities with other disciplines, the design management staircase, the three pillars and purpose, design management tools, and what would be the issues ahead of us. So, okay. This figure, what do you see? There's a business manager on the left, and on the right, there are designers. So, and there's a design manager in between. So there's a question how he will integrate these two. Now, so we'll define first what is design. So design, according to the Good Design Plan of 2007, it is a process of joining creativity and innovation in delivering value to the product or project. It's more than just styling or image. That necessarily mean a creation of something new and its potential to change the company and to stand out among competitors, according to Kotler and Rath, 1984. So those are the meanings of design. How about business? Business is the activity of buying and selling goods for financial gain. So that's why you're doing business, for financial gain. Ba't ka pa nag-business kung malulugi ka, di ba? So next, they conduct market study and research. They do competitors check. They have to compare others from other people, from themselves, para to improve themselves, and how to compete with them and have an edge sa kanila, no? And then it aims to sell and gain from it. And in the financial terminology, when you hear the word bottom line, like MBA, may nagsabi siya, ano ba bottom line yan? It means, anong magigain ko dyan? Anong financial profit ko dyan? So, to be na practical side, yung mga nagtitesis dyan, yung mga panel of juror, para sila mga businessman, mga stakeholders yan, kinikritik yung design mo. So, ang isipin nila, anong mapapala ko dyan? Anong bottom line dyan? Maganda ba yan? Would it benefit my company? Parang ganun ang nangyayari sa mga thesis deliberation, no? So, ganyan ang thinking ng mga panel jurors. So, okay. So, what is design management? According to Design Management Institute of London, design management is the business side of design. It bridges between design and business. It has a process, business decisions, and strategies for innovation and creativity to enhance quality of life and provide organizational success and lasting value. Oh, so design management is a combination or synergy of the creative realm. The creative realm, the business side, isa yan. Kasi karamihan sa mga arkitekto, design, sorry to say sa mga arkitekto, I'm an architect also, ha? Pero yung architects kasi na design lang ng design without thinking, maga parang design without thinking, pasok without thinking, gusto ko niyan. Hindi ganun. Iba ang approach pag design management na. Okay? So, what are the objectives of the design management? First objective is develop and maintain a business design environment. Business lagi inisip niyan, hindi ka lang nide-design, ha? Kasi, in order to survive the world of business, kailangan meron kang thinking na ito dapat magbe-benefit ang tao. Okay? Second, is to achieve the strategic goals through design by creating the company's own identity or branding. Okay. Sample. SM. Pag nakita mo yung logo niya, alam mo na SM yan. McDo. Logo lang yan, alam mo na. Jollibee. Diba? Pag nakita mo pa lang yung kanyang logo, alam mo na, ito yung company niya. And third, establish and manage efficient, effective, and code-compliant design systems. Ito ang pinaka-importante because law or codes are non-negotiable. Okay? So, hindi lang basta nag-design kaya, you have to understand the legal side of design. No? Okay. So, before to dwell to further, let's go back to history. Ano yung history niyan about ng design management and its evolution? So, in 1940s to 1970s, okay, 1944, okay, the British Design Council was established by Dr. Hugh Dalton, an industrial designer. Nandiyan na pala yung design management. It's not yet the term. The idea of design management noong 1944 na hindi pa pinapanganak ang magulang ko. most of us talaga hindi pa napapanganak dito. The 1951 Aspen Design Conference was founded by Walter Papke, a Chicago industrialist. He said that design serves as a function of management. Okay. In 1964, architectural management terminology was introduced by architects Brunton, Baden-Hillard, and Boubier. They tackled the job management and office management. Okay, what's the difference between the job management and office management? The job management is the micro approach. Okay, as an individual, what is your job? As a project architect, what is your job description? Individual approach yan. Ngayon, ang office management is the macro side. Ano man ang ginagawa mo as an individual would affect as a whole the company. Okay? 1965, Design Management Publication, it was introduced by Michael Farr, the first publication about design management. 1975, the Design Management Institute in Massachusetts, College of Arts in Boston was established. Okay? 1975 yan. So, kakapanganak ko pa lang yan. Yeah, medyo may edad na ako. Okay, 1980s to present. Robert Blake in 1980 introduced the design management system at Philips Electronics. Okay, akala ko before, a design management is only intended for architectural firm or developers. No, design management is for all. Okay? Because there's a system in terms of design. Philips is producer of bulbs. Okay? So, meron silang system na sinusunod na naging effective para ma-market nila yung kanilang produkto. Okay? And then in 1990, there's a publication about design management, a handbook issues and methods by Mark Oakley, design management book by Bridget Deborah Bozotta, and a publication of design management papers from the London Business School by Peter Gorb. Yes, Peter Gorb na sa kanan. Okay? So, more on research talaga ito. Nag-aaralan talaga on how to improve the design on a business side. In 1992, the first international conference in architectural management sa England, ginanap yan. Hindi mo naka-attend yan. Kaka-graduate ko pa lang yan, 1992, sa PLM. 2007, nag-introduce ng ADMIRE, an award for design management, innovating and reinforcing enterprises, was founded in the European Commission. Okay? So, ito yung mismong nagbibigay ng award sa mga companies who are applying design management. And on 2009 to present, from ADMIRE, naging Design Management Europe or DME award na siya. It tackles about the resources, awareness of benefits, planning, process, and expertise. Limang bagay niyan, yun ang kailangan matutunan sa design management firm. Okay? Yan. So, ito yung evolution natin ng design management. In the 1960s, aesthetics components of design. Puro lang beauty. Okay? Tulad niyan ng mga sinauna, yung mga buildings, ang lalaki, very grandeur, pero ang lalaki. Mga designer, very intricate. Pero they only focus on aesthetic. Pagandahan, kasi nung unang panahon, pagandahan, pag maganda yung building mo, sikat ka na. Yun ang focus noon. And from 1960s to 1970s, systemizing the design function. May mga checklist na tayo and tools for quality control. No? So, ito yung mismong nag-guide, mga checklist na gagawin sa mga patao to come up with a better design, not just for aesthetics but also anong purpose niyan. Form follows function, yun ang nagsimula na rin yan. In 1980s to 1990s, strategic focus working along with production and marketing, dito na pumasok ang marketing and production. So if you're going to be in a developer, I've been into developers for so many years. Puro design lang akong ginagawa, pero pumapasok sa meeting yung mga marketing people, gumagawa ng mga collaterals, Tapos yung drawing mo, ipapasok nila doon at imamarket nila doon. So, gagawa ka ba ng balbon? Balbon na design, gagamitin ba nila yun? Hindi. Diba? So, inaayos mo yung trabaho mo, inaayos mo yung design mo para maging marketable yung drawing mo to the public. And in 2000, near 2000, present, innovation ito, computer age na tayo dito. So, innovation, it lead the market rather than respond to market needs. Before, reactive tayo. Pag sinabi na, ito in. Diba? Ito, sa kakakikilos. Ngayon, kailangan advance mag-isip ka na. Asa, para ang mangyayari, instead of pagbinenta mo ang item mo, yung design mo, saka magre-react sila. Hindi na ganun. Ang mangyayari, you put yourself into your design at iisipin mo, kung ako gagamit yan, magiging masaya ba ako? Ganun ang thinking dapat. Okay? Paano ko siya gagamitin? Would I be satisfied with my design? O mabubwisit lang ako? Okay? So, ano yung value and relevance ng design management? There are actually 9. No? Bear with me. Bibilisan ko na lang. Okay. Multidisciplinary approach. So, arkitekto, kadalasan design lang dyan ng design. Pero marami kang iisipin. Yan. Architecture, structural, MEPF, landscaping, architectural lighting, environmental signage, technical due diligence, legal, material understanding, business financial. Relevance number 2, research through benchmarking. Okay? So, the typical benchmarking, hinahanap mo, tinitingnan mo lang yung best, tapos susunod ka na sa kanya. Hindi dapat ganun. Ang iniisip mo talaga, better than the best. Okay? Yan ang purpose and value and relevance ng design management. Relevance number 3, socially driven design management. Hindi lang single person, hindi lang one color person, two colors, all colors. Okay? Yung sinasabi nila na Black Lives Matter, all lives matter na yan. Yun ang mangyayari dyan. Okay? Relevance number 4, public services. Okay, familiar kayo rito sa lugar nito. One of my projects, ito, sa when I was working with Century Properties. This is the first of its kind, the first ever in the Philippines, na beach resort. This is the Azure Residences in Bicutan. Okay? Kaya naging patok to. Relevance number 5, service design. Okay, nag-conduct ng study ang Europe survey. No? Pag maganda kasi service design mo on the design management, gumaganda ang performance ng company. Ito yung studies nila. Nag-conduct sila mga 250 companies in Europe. Ito yun, na naging effective sa kanila. Malaking benefits talaga ang nangyayari when company engage in design management. Because nag-improve in systems and processes nila. It improves the quality of work, naging more effective ang design projects, and has improved innovation activities. Relevance number 6, branding. Oh, I think familiar kayo dyan. Oh, sorry. Yan. Okay. So, Apple, kung makikita mo, kung tingin nyo kaya yung 1976, yung pa rin logo ng Apple, tatagal kaya yan. Diba? So, you have to innovate your brand. Improve. Don't be satisfied with a single design because there are more rooms to improve. Okay? Relevance number 7, business change management and strategy. So, ito. Sample lang to, Ayala Group of Companies. Ayala, nag-diversify sila ng companies. Ayala, meron silang banking, meron silang telecommunication, meron silang real estate, meron silang property management, meron silang energy, meron silang cars. Di ba? Meron silang foundation. If you innovate, if you diversify your skills, ang ganda ng takbo ng company. Because if one fails or nag-struggle, other companies would go up. Laging ganyan yan. Mag-struggle ang isa, pero mag-improve ang isa. Okay? Evidence number 8, scientific engineering and technological approach. So, ito yung mga list ng kailangan maintindihan ng isang designer. Okay? Isang design manager. Okay? This for the developers, no? Ito yung mga ginagawa namin. We conduct some investigation, genetic assessment, systemic analysis, wind tunnel. All of this. Ngayon, may dalawang bagay na ginagawa sa structural design. There is a code-based design and the other one is performance-based design. Yung code-based design, syempre, per se, code-based design, sinusunod nila what was stated or what is stated in the code. Kaya papansin mo structural niyan, over-design sila niyan. Why? To be safe. Ngayon, ang performance-based naman is ito ginagamit nila, seismic analysis, wind tunnel analysis, elevator, geotechnical assessment, ginagamit nila yan, building information model, ginagamit nila yan. Why? Kasi ito yung application pag nagtayo ng building, sinestimulate nila yan, pag itinayo yung building using code-based design, masyadong malakas, masyadong matibay yung building na napagasos ang developer. So, ang ginagawa, they apply this, tapos simulation, pwede pa palang mapababa ang cost ng building without sacrificing the quality and strength of the building. Meron nga ako nakausap from C-squared na nakakasave ata siya ng 25 pesos per square meter. Ganun siya. I think not just 25 eh. Malaki pa ata. I think 1.5, sorry. 1.5. Ang isang building kasi is nasa 30,000 yan per square meter. Construction cost yan. Pag ginamitan nila ng performance-based design, nagiging 28,000 na lang yan o 20,500. Diba? So, laking savings yan. And last is innovation. Yan. So, what makes your company unique from others in terms of products being offered? May mga condominium yan na may mga wifi na sa mga common areas. Yeah. Design style. Ano ba yan? Minimalism ba yan? Constructivism? Performance. Madali bang gamitin yan? Mabilis bang gamitin? Convenience. Madali bang mapuntahan yan? No? Environmental. Care for the environment. May STP, fluent discharge, ang ganyan. Social, o yung mga corporate social responsibility. SM, may isa ganyan. SM, Ayala, Robinsons, yan. Sales promotion. Okay? Minsan may mga promo sila dyan na yung mismong open spaces nila, mga balcony, instead of 100% selling. Sabi natin, okay, bibenta ko ang per square meter ng isang unit ko ng 2 million. 2 million yan, pero ang balcony, sabihin natin ito, 20 square meters of condominium unit. No? 20 square meters. The minimum nga is 18 eh, as per HLURB eh. 20, bebenta nila na 100,000 per square meter. Okay? So that's 2 million. Eh, may balcony siya. Balcony niya, sabihin natin mga 5 square meters. Okay. 5 square meters, ay may benta mo yan ng 100,000 per square meter din. Ay, hindi mabibenta yan kasi unit plus the balcony, ang mahal na yan kung mag 100,000 per square meter. So, ginagawa 50% discount. Discount kasi balcony lang naman yan eh. No, no walls, just floors, railings. That's it. So, there are developers na talagang change check nila na okay, ito yung maging cost niya pero hindi sila manulugi. So, what are the differences and similarities with other disciplines? Okay. So, we'll be comparing this with other discipline of management disciplines, okay? So, first, project management. Same approach on constraints. What are the three constraints? The cost, the quality and the time. Okay? Cost, quality, time. Yan lang laging iniisip ng project manager. Pero tayo iniisip natin, may kasamang design dapat in consideration yan. Okay? So, construction management, malagi ang construction manager, lagi iniisip ng deadline yan. Hindi nag-iisip yan minsan ng ano, ng aesthetic. Basta matapos ko lang, okay na ako dyan. Hindi ganun yun. Tayo, may aesthetic quality. Ay, yung mga design managers yan. Okay. Architectural design. Okay, mga arkitekto. We do the layout, we do the aesthetics, but design management includes the practicality and the business in mind. The practicality yan. Minsan nagdi-design ka ng mga shape na ganyan. Minsan may mga dead end corners ka na pala na hindi nag-add value sa plano mo. Okay? Business management. Okay, mga nag-MBA. You know, same intentions to save on money. Laging ganyan yan. And earn. Pero tayo, hindi natin kino-compromise ang aesthetics. Mga design managers, they don't compromise on aesthetics. Materials procurement management. Yung mga procurement managers na yan. Yung procurement understanding, inaalam din nila. Pero tayo, naghanap tayo ng alternative. Kaya, saan papapwede kumuha? Na mababa ang cost, pero the quality is still there. Resource management, okay, the resource efficacy, but sa design managers, kinukonsider design performance efficiency. Okay? Di lang basta efficiency, efficacy, effectiveness, but also efficiency. Operational management, okay? So, same approach on maintenance and operation. Pero tayo thinking ahead tayo niyan. Why? Before i-design yan, isipin mo na, before implement yan, yung sa design mo, isipin mo na, bagay kaya ito? Ano mangyayari kung ako gagamit? Ganun na mag-isip. Legal management is a long consideration, pero we focus on building codes and ordinances compliance. Kung isipin natin, hindi tayo mga lawyer, ha, yung mga design managers, hindi mga lawyers yan. Pero we focus on building codes and ordinances. So, what are the 4DM staircase, so 4 steps or levels na tinutukoy about design management? First is the level 1, no design management. Ito yung I design because I just like it. Ito yung design with preference. Yung gusto mo lang mangyari. Okay, kwento lang. Meron ako sa nakausap na interior designer. Sikat siya. Sikat. Naglagay siya ng ang design siya, may CR doon, he and she, dapat he and she yan eh. Naglagay siya ng name, the word he or she na may ilaw na neon light, so medyo maganda, sa loob ng CR. So, ng CR yan ha. So, minsan pag nagkamali ka, baka magpasok mo pa lang doon, CR pala ng lalaki yun, o CR pala ng babae yun. Kinamasya ko sa kanya yun. Sabi ko, bakit ganyan? Ba't nasa loob yung logo ng ano mo? Ng mismong name ng CR na yan or he and she. Sabi niya sa akin, ba't ka nakikialam? Diba? Go F yourself, parang gano'n nangyayari. So, parang, ano ba itong nangyayari? Parang, hindi ka na nag-iisip. Diba? Parang, design without thinking na nga nangyayari. Gusto mo lang mangyayari. As is, ganyan lang. Hindi dapat gano'n ang arkitekto, hindi dapat gano'n ang designer. Diba? Ay, sorry. And then, next, level 2, design management as a project. Remember, okay, in project management, a project is an endeavor with an end. Laging natatapos yan. Okay? So, thinking ng tao, just finish a project and then I'm good. Satisfy na ako. Yan, design with repetition na lang, ulit-ulit na lang. Start and. Ganun na nangyayari. Okay? Level 3, design management as a function. Okay, job description mo to. I do this because the management told me so. Sumusunod ka lang sa process. Okay? Pagka parang you're just a robot. Huwag naman ganun. Okay? And level 4, design management as a culture. where creativity, technology, and design skills are implemented, are used. So I'm doing this for to improve myself and for the company's growth. It is design and leadership. Kumbaga parang the reason company hire you because they believe you are going to make a difference. Hindi ka uto-uto. Hindi ka lang susunod sa proseso. Hindi ka lang paulit-ulit na gagawin tapos dito start and susunod ka lang na ito gusto maging design. Hindi. The reason company hire you is because they believe in you. You're going to be part of their growth because you're going to contribute to their company. Okay, take note of that. Okay, so saan level ka na? Saan level? Dapat paakyat ka eh. Okay? And then, there are three pillars and purpose. Ito yung sinasabi ko na parang sa project management. Okay, the three pillars. The cost, the quality, and time. Okay, anong purpose, anong aim ng design manager? It's to bring down the cost during construction, during operation and maintenance. To increase the quality, building performance, aesthetics, and public appeal. And to lessen the time. Okay? To give you more time to yourself during construction and during operation and maintenance. Okay? So, what are the DM tools? So, design management tools. Ito yung ginagamit namin sa when I was working in a developer, no? So, may drawing checklist kami. Okay, from schematic, design development, construction documentation, initiate for construction or IFC. Or we call it an SM in the implementation plan. Material design specification. Okay, design review and compliance checklist. Ito may sumusunod sa mga code, mga ordinances, company standards, kung meron man. Building information modeling. Okay, ito yung tinatawag na design clashes or the clash analysis. Okay? The Gantt chart, importante. Scheduling yan. Para malam makita mo yung progress. Nasaan ka na? Late ka na ba? Early ka pa ba? Would you meet the deadline? The Gantt subcharts. Ito yung mga design managers na mahawak ng not just one project, but multiple projects. Okay? Kasi para malaman niya, itong mga design na to, eh mo kapos, ito naman di pa gano'n urgent, o itong tao ko ilipat ko muna rito para ma-meet namin deadline. Financials for budget monitoring, yan. Soft costs such as the consultancy fees and per square meter, hard cost or the construction cost. Okay? And marketing, how do you sell your product that will be very appealing to the target market. Okay? So, anong issues ahead of us, no? So on as a design manager, we look forward to it. We're thinking forward. So, managing design systematically, the process always needs to improve due to constant change of the people's need. Hindi yan laging nakapirme sa isang satisfaction. Ang tao hindi nasasatisfied. Kaya okay. Kung napanood yung pursuit to happiness, because happiness, talagang laging pinupursu yan. Because people laging hindi satisfied sa kinalalagyan nila. That's why, bakit nagkakaroon ng maraming phones, ng more designs, more options. Because more people prefer this, prefer that. I want this, I don't want that. Ganun na sila. Oh, according to Paul Rand, design is the method of putting form and content together. So design is so simple, that's why it's so complicated. Okay? Design management issue number two, managing design as a strategic asset positioning. Branding approach and business styles keep on changing due to competition naman. Okay? Una, your focus on people. Their satisfaction should be met. Their happiness should be met. Ngayon, competition naman. Sino mo yung mismong kalaban mo dyan na baka bagang matabunan ka? Okay? So, you have to improve, innovate, embrace the change. Good design is good business. Yan ang sabi ni Thomas Watson, IBM Chairman and CEO. And game issue number 3, managing design for innovation through rapid technology change. So computerization versus manual approach. Yan, medyo matinding competition yan. No? So a good designer must rely on experience and precise thinking and on pedantic exactness, no magic will do. Said by Niklaus Emil Wirth. Okay, what do you mean pedantic? Okay. Naka-encounter na ba kayo ng mga tao na miski wrong spelling, kinokorek ka na? Okay, yung mismong mali lang yung preposition mo, kinokorek ka na? Ganun yung meaning na pedantic. So ito, kailangan precise ka, more on the details ka, marunong ka tumingin. Para maging, kasi once na tatak sa'yo ng ganun, magparang ganun kang tao na maano ka, meticuloso ka, meticuloso sa mga ginagawa, you know the details, you're always going to details, tatatak sa tao sa inyan, lalo yung management, ay ito, magaling itong tao to. He is a reliable person. Because he knows what he's doing. Ganun siya. So in a nutshell, sinagsabi nito, design is not just what it looks like, design is how it works. Big jobs. Apple Incorporated founder. What designers need to learn that is the most important thing is the language of business world. Only by learning the language you can effectively voice the arguments of design. Peter Gorb, pioneer in design management. And third, I leave this to you. When all businesses are designing value-added, user-oriented, desirable products, it will be those with good design management practices that will be able to stay ahead. If you keep on innovating, keep on improving yourself for the benefit of yourself, for the benefit of the company, to be better company, and to be number one, gandang mangyayari sa company at sa iyo. Gaya ng Ayala ngayon, the number one real estate company. Hindi nga lang makapasok doon. Okay? So ito yung mga projects ko when I was in Friendship Properties in SM. Okay? I applied design management. Because if you apply design management sa inyong ginagawa, your products will be better. It would look very appealing to the public. And ang kinanggan nito, para tumatagal ang value ng product mo, ng design mo. Kasi you're thinking ahead. Your design is ahead of the time. Okay? So, again, thank you for inviting me. This is John Sakdalan. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm done. Hello?
Ayan.
Yes, po.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Architect Sakdalan, for that informative and fruitful discussion. This will surely help us improve our skills in our design subjects. So, ayun nga.
Excuse me. Sabi, guys, wala yung PowerPoint ni Architect. Nakita ba yung PowerPoint ko?
Yes po, Architect.
Yes po, yes po.
Okay. Sabi kanina rito, EJ Tech yan. Sabi ni EJ Tech, guys, wala yung PowerPoint ni Architect.
Yes po, kanina lang po yan. Nung
nag-start okay, okay.
Po namin kayong introduce.
Okay, kinabahan naman ako doon. Kaya yung laway ko. Okay, sige. Okay.
Yes, partner, go ahead.
So, ayun nga, sabi niyo po kanina, we don't satisfy in a single, we don't need to satisfy in a single design because there are always room for improvement. So ayun po, na-realize ko na tama nga po kasi many of us na parang kapag nagawa po ng mga architectural plates para inuulit-ulit na lang po yung design, yung border, yung penmanship, ganun. Then realize na hindi ka po dapat mag-focus sa isang design lang kasi marami ka pong marami ka pa pong dapat malaman, marami ka pa pong dapat matutunan, and alam mo sa sarili mo na mag-i-improve ka.
Yes, yes. Tama yun, tama yun. Pag nakita na lang company ko yan, nag-apply ka ng work, pag nakita na lang yung value mo because you're contributing to the company, your value would increase and they would recognize you, they would see you as a reliable person, at makikita ka nila na, oy, ready for promotion to. Pwede ma-promote ito. Laging dapat ganun na thinking natin.
Yes.
Because the world is keep on changing. If you don't change yourself, ay nako, pupulutin ka sa kangkungan. Okay? Ayun lang.
Yes, I agree with what you said, partner. No, there are always more rooms for improvement. And also, architect, natutunan ko rin po yung kahit pabilisan nyo lang po nabanggit is yung difference ng code-based design and performance-based design. Kumbaga, may nakaka-apekto po talaga yun sa magiging outcome ng ating project. And also, it is important din na your design must consider innovation and improvement para ma-step up po yung game natin in the competition dahil marami po tayo mga other factors din na nasa competition. And tama. Also, we also have to consider practicality and business in mind. And isipin natin, how will it be used before being implemented? Ganun din po ako mag-isip ng design concept. Mas iniisip kong ako yung nasa position po ng user, mas magiging okay ba to kapag ganito or ganyan. Thank you po, architect, for those key points po na na-share po ninyo. Okay, I think you. Now po, it is time for us to hear some of our viewers' sentiments and questions po.
Yes.
Okay, so nakikita po natin sa comment section. Siguro po, may question din po ako, architect.
Mm-hmm.
Sa tingin niyo po, how do you deal with yung mga clients po na nagpaparevise ng designs pero yung gusto po nilang mangyari is impractical, like hindi po makakabuti sa magiging outcome? How do
okay.
you deal
with that? Okay, I've encountered that no? One project itong lately na po ako. Pabago siya ng pabago. Pero, ang ginagawa ko, pinapakita ko sa kanila on the practical side. So, ma'am, gusto niyo ba talaga yan? Kasi ganito po yan. Maganda po yan, ma'am. Maganda. Pero, ito yung maging implication niyan. Ito yung magiging changes niyan. Tapos, sabi ko lang sa kanila na, kung ito yung changes ng design mo, ito yung magiging cost niyan. Itong maging effect niyan on the design, on the time, and on the cost. And on the quality. Lagi yan ang sinasabi ko sa kanila. Hanggang sa ma-realize nila na, ay, oo nga, no, tama ka, architect. Kailangan, you have to voice out your idea. Eh. Hindi yung para ka lang na sumusunod sa kliyente mo na, hindi ka naman aso eh. Kaya ka nga hinire to help them. To help them understand, kasi may mga clients na, ito gusto ko. Ang hirap nung ganun, pero you have to manage them. That's why clients hire you to help them understand better design para magkaroon ng magandang resulta ang kanilang building, ang kanilang house, ano man ang structure na yan. Remember, architects are there to help improve the lives of the people, of their client. Laging ganun yan. Hindi tayo mga aso. Okay? Explain to them. Ma'am, ito magandang idea nyo, pero ito yung mangyayari. Oh, ma'am, pag sino po natin, pag ginawa po natin yan, baka as per code, kailangan may idea ka rin about laws. As per code, hindi po pwede yan eh. Baka malintikan ho tayo yan. Pag nakita ng building official yan, hindi tayo sumunod, baka hindi ma-approvean yung ating occupancy permit. Laging yan eh. Ang kliyente, pag sinabi mo na binato mo yan ng, pag sinabi po ng code, sinabi po ng ordinance, ay urong yan. Because codes, ordinances, laws, non-negotiable yan. Importante yan. You have to have an idea about it. At kailangan, pakita mo sa kanila on the practical side of design. Because sila yung user. You're just helping them to realize it.
Okay po, thank you, architect. So ngayon po, mas na-realize ko po na talagang importante. Bilang second year pa lang naman po ako na importanteng mas ma makabisado and maisa puso, maisa isip natin ang laws and ordinances regarding architecture and designing, of course.
Oh, may building code kayo, di ba?
Yes,
building po. Laws?
Yes, po.
Yeah.
Okay, po, architect, we have a question po from one of our live viewers. This is from Christiana Lois. Where do you get inspiration po when designing?
Okay. Okay, if you want to get some inspiration, okay, there are three things that you can do. Isa pa, medyo oldies na ata eh. Okay? The first is, syempre magazines, mga ginagawa ng ibang arkitekto. Okay? Second is online. Okay? Nakikita mo sa Google, yung Google image, ganyan. But the most important talaga, ang naging striking sa akin, is travel. Pumunta ka sa iba't ibang lugar na magbibigay sa'yo ng inspiration. Kaya punta ka ng discus sa local lang. Although ngayon, medyo limited tayo, no? Kasi dahil nga sa COVID na yan, no? Pero, you get your inspiration through those three things, magazines, online, and travel talaga. No? Kasi, diyan mo makikita mo yung strength mo eh. Pag nakita mo, uy, pwede ko ma-apply to sa design ko? No? People would give you ideas, but remember, if it's a concept design, walang makakakontra sa'yo because it is your idea. Where do you get your ideas? Magazines, online research, travel. Three things yan. Okay? Huwag kang kumopi sa klase mo. Parang plagiarism yan. You check on them, okay? Maganda yun. Or you make your own design. Be resourceful. Para makakam up ka ng with your own design. Para magkaroon ka ng sarili mong signature. Okay? When I was teaching in PLM, meron mga estudyante dyan na naging very, very good in design. May mga design sila na ano na parang rocket ship pa ata yung concept niya. Saan niya nakuha yun? Saan niya nakuha yung idea na yun? The project was a building hotel. So, ang shape ng building niya, shuttle. Space shuttle. May pang isa nag-design dati wakaklase ko pa yun. Ang project namin is as a gasoline station. Ang concept niya, race car. Ba't ganito mag-isip ito? Diba? So you make your own identity. So, paano ma-improve yung sarili mo? Go to places. Kung makakita ka ng magandang building, baka pwede magamit mo yun. Pero remember, when designing, you have to understand also the materials. Diyan nadadali ang karamihan sa mga nagtitesis. Kung ako lang umuupo sa ano, kung i-apply ko design management, sasabihin ko sa estudyante, okay, anong material yan? ACP. Okay. Magkano kaya yan kung ilalagay ko yan? Kung ilalagay ko sa project na yan? Kasi diba sa thesis, naglalagay din tayo ng cost niya, diba? So if we're going to detail, okay, magkano yan per square meter? Pero ayoko maging ganun. Sobra na yun, no? Alam mo, mga thesis, nagsisimula pa lang mga siyan eh. So they will go into details na yan. They would know the details pag nagtrabaho na yan. Pero kailangan, ang sa akin, pag nagtitesis kayo, concept mo yan, I don't care. It is your design. Kung maganda, pangit, it's your design. Walang problema kung medyo chops yung itsura niyan. I don't care. Why? It is your design. Hindi ko pwedeng sabihin, hindi dictate na ang pangit ng design mo. Ay, dapat ito ginawa mong hindi. Because you are the designer. You are the architect. Okay? So, no one can dictate you but yourself. And how to improve yourself? With magazines, mga pictures na yan, online. travel. That's it.
All right. Thank you po. Thank you po for answering Miss Cristiana's question. Ayan, so Miss Cristiana, natutunan natin na marami talagang dapat i-consider ano sa pagde-design, hindi lang basta yung form kundi as well as yung magiging function, yung usage niya. Sir, ayan, we have another question from my partner. He asks, what's the difference po of working with individual clients and working for a company project naman po?
Individual and working for a company? Okay. Kunyari, yung isang individual is you own your own company. And then the other one is you work for the company. Tama ba yun?
Siguro something like that po. Or sa mga nagpapagawa lang po na
okay.
Mga clients.
Okay. Kung if you work for a client, okay, single project, you're the architect, single yan, no? Parang you own your own company. Company pa lang, ha? Ganun. Kasi ikaw yung nag-handle directly to the client. Eh. Ikaw gumagawa ng lahat-lahat. From designing, ikaw nagka-CAD, you do the estimates, kung maganda ba yan, as you do the research on materials, okay? You do the specifications. One-man team ka. If you work for a company, compartmentalize yung trabaho mo. May mga designers, merong mga nagla-landscape, merong nasa scale modeling, may ba nasa specification writing. So, distributed ang trabaho. No? So, instead na nag-iisa ka, ginagawa mo yung apat na yun. Sabihin, apat na yun. Na nababawasan ka ng trabaho. Pero don't be satisfied lang sa design lang. You have to understand also anong ginagawa ng ibang mga disciplines. Kasi if you keep on staying in one position, tulad sinabi ko kanina, if you keep on staying in one position, you won't improve. You really won't improve. But if you open yourself sa gantong sitwasyon na you do yourself all the specification, ganyan, estimate yan, ang laki na improvement. Laki na improvement sa sarili mo. No? So, if you're dealing with single client, you do everything. The stress even is there. The stress of dealing with client is there. Pag na-work in a company, yung stress, hindi lang sa'yo, hindi lang ikaw ang sumasalo. Maraming sumasalo. Ganti yan eh. Like kung sinasabi sa mga nakakasama ko, kapag may problema ka, i-share mo yung problema mo sa mga kasamahan mo. In terms of design. Sa company yan. Kanya, sample lang, pag sa company ka, you share your problem, ito yung kliyente, ano kayong pwede natin gawin? May collaboration. May tumutulong sa'yo. Okay? Pag individual, nakakahirap niyan. Ikaw sasalo yung sarili mong stress. Kaya ako nakalbo eh. Dati yung JCDSDZYN na yan. O, design. Ang itsura ko. Kalbo ako. Kasi ako sumalulat ng mga problema ng binabalo sa akin ng kliyente. No? And there's benefits kasi you reap the rewards. Mga, wala kang kasosyo sa earnings, di ba? Pero pag nalugi-lugi ka, ganun din yon. Ikaw lang sasalula. Pero in terms of the, kung mayroong kasamahan, working in a company, well, maga parang, pag when one rejoices, everyone rejoices, ang sarap-sarap niyan. Pero pag one becomes in sorrow, hati-hati kayo sa sorrow. Sa sorrowness niyan. Diba? So, well, advantages and disadvantages naman eh. Working singly, individually, or in a company. May mga advantages and disadvantages yan. Ang tanong lang is, how do you handle them? How do you handle stress? Yan ang talagang number one. Para mabawasan yung stress, enjoy your work. Hangga parang ka naglalaro. Kasi once na nag-enjoy ka sa ginagawa mo na, yung stress, nadyadyan pa rin yan, pero namamanage mo na siya. So whether individual, whether in a company, or in a group, It's all up to you.
Okay po, Architect. Thank you po. Kasi, yes po. Thank you po kasi hindi lang po basta designing yung natakil nyo dun sa tanong na yun, kundi pati work ethics po, no? Sa parehong situation. Thank you po for that answer, Architect, para kay Prince.
Next up, para mga tanong ata po ang arkitekto, ah. Yung mga ano, hindi about design management. So anyway, sige, kahit ano. Anything
goes. Aspiring architect po. Ayan po. Ito naman po is a question from Mr. Ronel Repil. He asks, ano po yung experience niyo sa pag-manage ng project na malaking lesson po para sa inyo?
Okay. Naging malaking lesson sa akin yan is do not work in silos or as individual. Ang term ng when I was working in century, yung sasabi lang, do not work in silos. Ano yung ibig sabihin ng silos? Silos is nag-iisa ka lang. Huwag may sarili kang mundo. No. Huwag kang ganun. Kasi may time nangyari sa akin niya, I work in silos in Robinson's Land as a project manager. Meron ako isang project, may isang situation na hinandle ko lang sarili ko. Kasi talaga, ako lang. May problema, ako lang. Eh, meron akong kasama, meron akong senior project manager na pwedeng katulong. Meron akong VP for corporate planning na pwedeng tumulong sa akin. Pero sinolo ko siya. Na-solve yung problema, how many months? 2 years. That was the biggest mistake in my life. In a single project, na maliit lang naman, it was worth only, I think, mga 500,000. Mas umabot ang 2 years, na instead na mas-solve siya in how many days? O how many weeks? 1 week, kaya na eh. That was my fault. The biggest mistake of my life was I was working in silos. As in talaga, gusto kong i-solve to kasi kaya ko to, ganun. Hindi. Pag tingin mo hindi mo kaya, sumi ka na, seek help na. Why? Because you're passing the problem to your immediate supervisor na pwedeng tumulong sa'yo. Kasi ang nangyari nga sa akin, hindi ko pinapasa. Mabot ng 2 years. Napagalitan ako noon. Grabe, hiyang-hiya talaga ako noon. No? So, basta may problema, try to solve it muna. Pag hindi mo kaya, seek help. Ganun yan. Para hindi ka nag-iisa sa problema na hinaharap. Kasi, pangit lang pakinggan, pero pinasa mo yung problema dun sa immediate head mo. O, bahala ka na mag-solve, binigay ko na sa iyan eh. Pero hindi. You have a play to part pa rin eh. Pero, ang part mo naman, ikaw na mag-follow up sa boss mo. Ma'am, sir, ano po yung gagawin natin dito? Ano na po yung ating action? Ano po yung ating improvement na kailangan iba to dito? Huwag niyo gayahin na single problem worth 500,000, it took me 2 years to solve it. Kung kailan ko pinasa sa immediate head. Grabe talaga, hiyang-hiya talaga ako nun. So, do not work in silos. Why? Kaya nga, may mga departments, kanya-kanyang departments yan, na maaring tumulong sa'yo. Pero kung may isang company dyan, na-encounter ko na yan, grabe, may isang company na they work in silos, ay, naku, ang hirap. Kaya kumalis. Kasi, you're seeking help. You want to learn something from them, but they're not sharing it with you. So, ba't ka patatagal doon? Remember, the reason you're in the company also, not just to contribute, but also to learn. But if the company, if that department is not helping you to solve the problem, ay, better think twice na. Kaya ako umalis sa isang kumpanya. The latest one. Not na itong same construct, ha? Before that. Talagang, sabi, hindi ako nakatagal. Why? Hindi ako nag-improve eh. Pag hindi ka nag-improve, you're just dragging yourself to work. Mga parang yan yung mga natutunan ko for the past years, tapos dito magiging bobo lang ako. Ay, mga boss, umalis na ako nun. Ayoko na. It's a big company, big developer, pero hindi ako nakatagal. Okay? So, work, do not work in silos. Always work collaboratively. Importante yan. Okay? Give your ideas and let them know that you have an idea. Huwag lang makikinig ka lang para ka lang, ano, parang utulang, parang ganun.
Ayan. Thank you so much po, Architect, for that answer. So, Ronel, pakinote yung naging tip sa atin ni Architect. Ano, never work in silos. Okay. Architect, actually, nakakatuwa din po na marinig po yung ishinare nyo po kasi since students pa lang naman po kami and yun pong naikwento nyo, talagang naging experience nyo po na pwede namin yung matutunan na hindi gawin sa future.
Yeah, thank you nga po rito sa invitation na to kasi I know I have an obligation eh to share what I've learned. Because if I do not share what I've learned, pinapatay ko lang sarili ko. Lahat ng learnings ko ay mamamatay lang hanggang sa akin. Dahil hindi ko kinalat sa iba. Ganun, kaya magandang idea yung ginagawa nyo na may mga webinar na ganyan. Why? Kasi yung mga speakers na yan ay nagmumultiply. Ay, ito natutunan ko sa speaker. Ito natutunan ko sa isang webinar kaya ganyan. Mga parang miski maliit lang yung nabigay mong contribution as a speaker, pero malaking impact sa kanila. Kaya maganda yung gantong ina arkitekturo. Maganda yan. Tuloy nyo lang.
Thank you po, Architect. And of course, kami rin po ay sobrang thankful po sa pag-accept niya sa invitation. Thank you po. I think, sir, we have accommodated all of their queries naman na po. And once again, thank you po for sharing with us your knowledge na makakatulong sa aming studies and of course, sa career. At this juncture, we would like to virtually give you this certificate of appreciation for being with us virtually today. This certificate of appreciation is hereby presented to Architect John Christopher D. Sakdalan II of UAP for imparting their knowledge and insights as a guest speaker of Arkitekturo, an online lecture series held this 10th day of January 2021 as part of the Project TAP via YouTube live stream. Together, let's take a step forward. Signed by yours truly, Daniel Angeli G. Pastrano, Event Head and Acting Student Council Vice President, Mr. Ezekiel Joshua A. Punsalan, Project TAP Head, Acting Student Council Auditor, and Ms. Trisha Danica L. Belizar, Acting Student Council President. Thank you po once again, Architect.
Thank you. Sorry, nawala tao kanina. Okay, thank you. If you've learned something.
Thank you po. We hope to see you po in the future for similar seminars po like this.
Okay. Thank you.
Once again, thank you very much to both of our speakers, Sir Santi Tedranes Iray and Architect John Christopher Sakdalan II, for sharing their precious time and wisdom with us in this third episode of Arkitekturo.
Ayan, talaga namang naging napaka-fruitful ng dalawang discussion natin ngayon, partner. Ano, dahil ang first talk natin is of course about morals, about life skills, and the second one is about our career, which is architecture. Talaga namang nakakatuwa na naging ganito ka successful ang ating third episode. And of course, for sure, ang ating live viewers din is may natutunan for today. Alright, again, magpo-proceed na po tayo, alright, for the second round, of course, ng ating Guess That Song Rat. Ayan, sa ating mga live viewers, paki-comment naman if you're still here with us and ready na kayong manalo ng shop vouchers and sunglasses from, of course, Boujee Shop M&L and Sweet Hangover. Once again, thank you so much to our sponsors for sharing with us their sponsorship for today's episode. Ayan, ready na po ba kayo, ating mga live viewers, para sa second round of Guess That Song Right? Alright, so basically, same mechanics lang rin naman from the first round. Paki-comment ang song title and the artist, and including your name and your blog. Pero this time, hindi na song title ang song title ang ipapakita namin, kundi jumbled order ng lyrics of a song. So, yung pagkakasunod-sunod ng mga lyrics, bale medyo ginulo namin, i-jumble namin, para maipakita sa inyo, and you have to decipher kung ano ang song title na ito. Of course, together with the artist. Ayan.
So for this round, we will pick 4 winners of shop voucher and 2 winners of sunglasses from Boujee Shop M&L. Thank you once again to our generous sponsors.
Ayan. Alright, reminder lang pala na i-screenshot, okay? I-screenshot din nyo yung screen kung saan lumabas ang inyong name kapag kayo ang napili na tama nakasagot ng answer. Alright, let's begin na, no? Thank you once again to our generous sponsor. So, let's begin with the first item of round 2. First item, we have here this one. Partner.
So, ayan, ang ating first lyrics na naka-jumbled ay di matatapos itong gulo. And ang last line ay, at ang hustisya ay para lang sa mayaman.
Ayan, so clue na, OPM po ito. Ano? Ano kayang title nito, partner? Very ano siya. Alam ko magandang kanta to na talaga naging iconic sa industriya ng music in the Philippines.
And maganda talaga yung ano niya, yung mismo
message.
That
is right. Ano, ayan, wala pa ba nakakahula ng ating...
I think wala pa po.
Mm-hmm. Abang-abang lamang tayo.
So, ayan, may nanalo... Wait.
Alright.
Ayan. So, medyo congratulations.
Medyo nagkulo lang ano, kasi sunod-sunod yung comments.
Congratulations to JC Romualdo.
Hindi pulat dilaw, tunay na makalaban. Ang kulay at tatak ay di siyang dahilan.
Ayan, again, congratulations, Romualdo. And don't forget to screenshot din this timestamp and message our Facebook page.
Congratulations, Kuya JC! Ayan, pa-screenshot na lang po and message the FB page of PLM Cab Student Council. Alright, for the next item, ito namang next na song na ito is, of course, suhulaan nyo pa rin ang song title, artist, and include your name and your block. Next item po, we have here a 4-line stanza. Alright, so first line, because I've been aiming for heaven above. The last line, babe, you don't have to wait on me. Ano kaya ang song title nito at sino ang kumanta? Alright, paki-comment na lang sa ating comment section below ang inyong mga answers together with your name, of course, and your blog. Ayan, parang ano to, international to, partner, no? International.
Yes. Ayan, sabi ni Erica Cortero Aray.
Ayan, nag-yehey na si Kuya JC. Thank you rin po. Right, meron na tayong winner. Congratulations, I mean, congratulations, Miss Faith Urquia. Of course, that is Sanctuary by Joji.
If you've been waiting for falling in love, baby, you don't have to wait on me.
Ayan. Congratulations, Miss Faith Urquia. Pa-screenshot na lang po nitong timestamp na to and message our FB page later. Next item, let's proceed now, partner.
So for our next item, we have 4 lines stanzas here. For the first line, huwag ka nang mag-alinlangan sa atin, di ka. And for the last line, bibitawan, ikaw yung paraiso, di ba?
Ayan, OPM to. Yun lang yung kaya
ko ibigay.
OPM, ayan. So for this round nga pala, meron tayong 6 na winners, ano? So nakakadalawa na po tayo ng winners. 4 na lang. Pakihulaan po ang song na ito. This is an OPM song. Ano pa bang clue pwede natin ibigay? Parang hindi na.
Oo, mahuhulaan agad nila.
Okay. Meron na po bang nakahula? Alright! Congratulations, Miss Art of Fleur. Si Ate Sir Ata to. Congratulations po! Ayan. Congratulations po, Miss Art of Fleur. Ayan. This is Urong Sulong by Kio and Alison Shore. Ayan. Pa-screenshot na lang po and message our FB page later. All right, for the, I think this is the fourth item. Ayan. Partner, ano kaya ang title ng kantang ito?
Yes, oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust. And the last line said, I said, oh, I'm drowning in the night.
Hmm. Alright, so ang makakuha po ng correct answer na ito ay kakantahin po ni Prince after.
Siyempre, do it ba?
Oh, sige. Ready ka po kayo? Mga live viewers, magkakala ng online concert. Alright, wala pa po
ba?
Wala pa bang nakakahula ng song na ito? Alright, so ang makakahula po ng correct answer for this song ay makakatanggap ng shop vouchers from our sponsor. Once again, thank you so much, Boujee Shop.mnl, and of course, Sweet Hangover. Thank you so much po for being with us in the third episode of Arkitekturo. Okay, wala pa po yata nakakahula. Very challenging naman pala itong ating next item. Alright, we have it here, Miss Erica Cortero, right? Or hindi po ba yon ang tamang sagot? Okay, hindi po yon ang tamang sagot. Medyo nagkaroon po tayo ng spelling error doon. Sige lang po, take your time po to song. Alright, ayan, medyo na-correct na ni Miss Erica Cortero. Congratulations, Miss Erica Cortero. Yes, this is Blinding Lights by The Weeknd. Ayan, to screenshot na lang po nitong timestamp na ito. Miss Erica, once again, congratulations po sa inyo. And of course, thank you to our sponsors. Next up, we have a last item na ba ito? Or second to the last, partner?
Second to the last, I think.
Alright, let's see. The next song that we have here is this one.
I'd walk through fire for you. And the last line said, oh honey. So, comment your answer. Comment your answer in the comment section.
Sige, maghihintay kami. Just take your time as long as ang makakakuha ng tamang sagot is correct ang spelling with the artist. And of course, paki-include na lang rin ang name ninyo para mas madali naming ma-confirm if kayo talaga yung nanalo sa item na iyon. Alright, I'd walk through fire for you. That's the only thing I'll ever do. Ano kaya ito? Very challenging naman pala. Ayan, maghintay lamang po tayo na makakakuha ng correct answer. Okay, I think we have na po a winner. Tama po ba sa ating technical committee? Ayan, I think we have na po si Miss Rika Elaine. Okay. You have to input your name and blog. Alright, Miss Rika Elaine.
Congratulations! Again, congratulations to Miss Rika Elaine. Don't forget to screenshot this timestamp and message our Facebook page at PLM Kaop Student Council.
Alright, ito na ang huling item para sa round na ito, para sa game natin na Guess That Song, right? Okay, so paunahan na lang po, dahil ang makakukuha ng tamang sagot ay magkakaroon ng sunglasses, of course, from Boujee Shop MNL. Ayan, so next item we have, last na po ito. Ayan, meron itong lines na talagang jumbled and you have to decipher kung ano po ang song title. And I don't even need your love yung simula. Pero hindi natin alam kung yun talaga yung simula. Dahil naka-jumbled po ito. And then the last line is make out like it never happened. And that we were nothing. Okay, so ano kayang title nito? Ipaki-comment na lang po sa ating comment section right here. Ang magiging answer ninyo. Of course, together with your name and block. Please don't forget to input it. Ano kaya magiging ano? Sino kaya ang mananalo nito? Sunglasses ito from, of course, Boujee Shop M&L. Wala pa po. Wala pa po nakakuha ng correct answer. Okay, we have one na yan. Congratulations, Miss Ali Garcia. This is somebody that I used to know by Gotye and she is from 3-1. Ayan, na-input niya ang kanyang name and blog. Congratulations! Yan, this is somebody that I used to know. Thank you so much po sa mga sumali and congratulations once again to our winners of the game called Guess That Song Right. Once again, thank you so much to our sponsors, Boujee Shop M&L and of course, Sweet Hangover. Kindly message our FB page together with the screenshot for proof of winning to claim your prizes later. And for the winners pala na hindi, who are unable to screenshot their names kanina, don't worry dahil this live stream will be uploaded on our channel. And you can take a screenshot na lang sa timestamp kung saan po kayo nanalo. Basta within this day, may message na po ninyo ang FB page ni PLM Calp Student Council to claim your prizes. And to our viewers, we hope you have learned something useful in your studies and life skills from today's webinar. Thank you so much for attending today and please look forward to more of this in the next few months. And to be updated, of course, on our future seminars like this, kindly like our Facebook page, PLM Kaup Student Council, tweet us with the hashtag Arkitekturo_F3, and follow us on Twitter and Instagram, it's at KaupSCOfficial. And of course, support our One View, One Step Forward campaign by subscribing to our YouTube channel and watching our videos. It's PLM Architecture on YouTube. Thank you so much, everyone! Once again, I am Angeli Pastrano.
And I am Prince Aldunose, your host for Arkitekturo Episode 3. Thank you, have a good day, and stay safe, Arkistas!
Bye!
Bye! Thank you.